broadcasting live from beautiful midtown Manhattan, where on a clear night you can almost see Paula Poundstone relapsing and hanging out outside around Girl Scout meetings. It's the Ron and Fez Show. And I'm your announcer, Spike the Metal Flosser. And now let's introduce your host. The guy's disappointed that letters for Santa this year had to be checked for anthrax, and that instead of coal, all naughty children will be receiving spores. Here they are, Rob Bennington, Fez Watley, Radio's Little Helpers.
Oh, Boris, Boris, Boris. Buddy, it's the Ron and Fez Show.
Get in there, buddy.
My name's Ron, and I made a robot, and I named him Fez.
How are you tonight, sir?
You can't even tell he's a robot.
More cool drinks, sir?
Oh, God, how I would love to have a robot to get me cool drinks.
The pup breaks to the left. This is the way we wash the clothes.
It is the Ron and Fez Show. We'll be with you until 11 o'clock tonight.
Hiya.
Sweet Melissa will be joining us tonight, Fuzzy.
Nice.
So I consider tonight a good night.
Any night with Sweet Melissa is a good night.
Fuzzy, who do we love?
Sweet Melissa?
Yes.
Okay. I just want to make sure.
On the bad side, Joe Poo will also be coming in tonight.
Wow, the Yang is here.
Hello. Fez, who do we hate?
Joe Poo.
Yes. So we'll have fun. No big-ass simulcast tonight, Fuzzy, when we spent 2 hours watching the Michael Jackson special last night on CBS.
Michael Jackson, 30 years, touching kids.
Maybe he did touch some children now and then, but come on, it's Michael Jackson! Michael Jackson!
Everybody loves Michael Jackson, Fuzzy.
Especially Michael Jackson.
He looks fantastic.
Oh, he's well-preserved.
Yeah, he is. You know, if he was, like, missing for years, would we claim that this guy is lying? That's not Michael Jackson?
We would have to if the Michael Jackson we knew, even as recently as the Off the Wall album, disappeared then.
Yeah.
And then this Michael Jackson showed up and said, no, it is me. You know, I've had skin problems.
Well, even...
We wouldn't believe.
Even Michael Jackson from Thriller. He looks nothing like him. And that was the big star, Michael Jackson.
Right.
But what's not to like there, Fezzy?
I think it's all in the lighting.
He got together with the family, and then you and I could just watch TV and yell things. And get paid for it.
Like we do anyway.
Yeah, like we do on weekends. So that was kind of fun. Tonight, Fezzy, strange stuff about kids and Christmas letters coming out.
Yeah, it's the Santa Claus letters. Of course, every year they do Operation Santa Claus, where kids' letters to Santa that come to New York City.
Yeah.
You know, it all started way back when postal workers started just answering these things themselves.
Now, did they always come to New York? Like, if it says North Pole, would they just send it to New York?
Yeah, I think it just came to New York anyway.
So, if you write Santa Claus, North Pole, and you put a stamp on it,
mm-hmm.
They would have just shipped it to New York, like Miracle on 34th Street, that big movie.
Right, yeah. For some reason, they get letters addressed to Santa Claus, either at the North Pole or at the Bronx Zoo, thinking that's where the reindeer live.
You're lying.
No, uh-uh.
Now, that would only be local kids that would do that. I can't imagine kids in Arizona going, obviously, they're in the Bronx Zoo.
So they said that the Postal Service in New York usually receives 400,000 letters
wow.
addressed to Santa Claus, North Pole, and or Bronx Zoo.
Now, did you do this when you were a kid? Did you mail out a letter to Santa Claus?
Yeah, I think I did a couple years.
I used to just mail them out to Satan.
Really?
Yeah.
Misspelling Santa?
Dear Satan, kill my older brother. Oh, yes, and give me powers beyond anyone can imagine.
I do believe...
Dear Satan, my little friends tell me that you're not real, but I don't think so.
Yeah.
I'm going to keep believing in you.
Yes, Virginia, there is a Satan.
Santa Claus is coming to town.
There you go, Fuzzy.
Nice. So now the situation is they always have people that take some of these letters through Operation Santa Claus and answer these kids' wishes. Well, the situation...
Oh, I see. So they would open it, and if it's a poor kid...
Right.
And he asks for something that isn't too big.
Yeah.
Not the kids are going, can I have a real gun?
Sure. Yeah. No, those letters do not get answered. At all. So someone would take it upon themselves to answer these letters. Well, now they're worried that with the anthrax scare, someone's going to see a weird envelope that just says Santa and or Satan.
Right.
Scribbled across it. And crayon, they're going to say, this looks too weird. I'm not going to open this.
Yeah, anything that's written by a child looks like it's written by a right-wing terrorist.
Right, because the letters that went to Tom Daschle and Tom Brokaw look like they were written by kids.
Right.
And even had third grade as the return address.
That reminds me of the kind of letters Fez gets.
Fan mail from some flounder. So now what they're going to do is they're going to irradiate all the letters to Santa. They're going to nuke them all so that no one has to worry about anthrax.
All right, now, how are these kids going to get presents if we burn up all their letters?
I think we're just running them through an X-ray or a microwave oven or something. They're just sterilizing them.
All right, so we're not burning them?
No, uh-uh.
I got $100 so they just burn them right off the bat.
So that people can still answer the Operation Santa Claus letters to good old Kris Kringle.
Now, this only happens in New York?
Well, this is how New York is handling it.
Yeah, but I wonder what they do with all those letters around the country.
Right, yeah. Okay, not every Santa letter must come to New York.
And you
how could that work?
You can't imagine. Well, 400,000 letters, that ain't all going to be local kids.
Right.
That would have to be every kid in the tri-state area. Thinking, oh, Santa lives at the Bronx Zoo, obviously.
He wants to be close to his reindeer.
Now, let's, why do we have the talking, though? Now, I don't mind a little Santa song, but...
I don't know.
The intro could die. So, I don't know, Fezzy. It kind of takes the Christmassy feel out of that for kids, doesn't it?
Yeah, I guess so. So, now, Santa is now caught up in terrorism.
Sure.
That's the situation this Christmas.
Pretty soon, we're going to have the elves patting the kids down before they go see him.
Oh, yeah. One of the situations also running is elves are now all federal employees.
Good.
They're being put on the federal government tab.
They all the kids that show up to see Santa should be carded. And was this bag with anybody else besides you?
Right.
Or was it totally in your control?
The kids are going to have to worry about the toys this year because I understand Santa's only allowed one carry-on on the sleigh.
Good.
Only one carry-on.
It's better safe than sorry.
Sure, it's all beefed up.
That's the way it should be, Fez. Because if something happens to Santa, you're going to feel bad, right?
Sure. Now we have to protect Santa, too, from terrorism.
The kids would rather have a safe Santa than get a lot of nice presents.
Right. And I believe that air marshals will be flying on the sleigh with St. Nick.
All right, Rob, you're on the Ron and Fez show. Hey, Rob.
Hey, guys, how you doing?
Yeah.
BAC1175. Hoo-hoo-hoo-ah! Hey, Ronnie, you're right. You put crayon in a microwave, that bad boy's flaring up, brother.
That's true.
Mm-hmm.
You can't put a crayon writing in there, Fezzy. It's going to be a flame on. You know, let me ask you something else. What about running some background checks on some of the reindeer and elves?
Oh, yeah. Thorough background checks.
Even when I was a kid, I always thought an elf was like a really short Arab. And I used to say to my parents, I'd go, are the really short Arabs going to be with this Santa Claus?
Yeah. Blitzen. Is that a Middle Eastern name? I'm not sure.
Where's that come from? Blitzen.
Yeah.
That's not
Blitzkriegen.
That's not an American.
Sounds right.
It's not an American name.
No, uh-uh. And it has to be checked.
Very strange.
Yeah. I also understand that Mrs. Claus is going to be taken to a secure location.
Good. Until after the holidays.
Right. So we won't ever know where she's at, and she probably won't be with Santa Claus.
Right.
You know, too often. Joint appearances.
And let's get rid of Rudolph. We don't need him just giving it away. Let's come in stealth.
I know. Why be a target? Unless you got to use that nose as an SOS.
Rudolph, with your nose so bright, we'll have to cut off your nose tonight.
She both think I'm cute.
That wonderful nose. Let's slice it off.
And why keep saying in a red suit? That's ridiculous. That's a target.
There's a big bullseye. Camouflage.
Put them all in white for when he's in places that have snow.
Right.
And then camouflage everywhere else.
Or I guess just a really extra, extra large ninja suit.
Oh, I'd love to see him in a ninja. I like to see the little elves as ninjas, too, because there's nothing funnier than a midget ninja.
Midget ninjas!
That'd be a cute Saturday morning show.
Teenage midget ninjas.
Let me ask you this. Is he wearing a flak jacket?
Oh, yeah, Ronnie. This year, that belly, it's going to shake like a bowl full of Kevlar.
Don't worry, kid. Santa's protected.
Santa is not taking any chances this year.
Oh, feel my belly, kid. That's 100% Kevlar.
Santa's belly hurts.
That's right. To protect me from terrorists.
I jumped on his lap and almost broke.
Hey, Josh. Josh, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, Josh.
How you guys doing?
Hey, buddy.
I called to tell you that Donner and Blitzen are originally from Holland, where Christmas started with the
right
shoes and all that.
But remember, Holland and Germany is where a lot of the terrorists were hanging out before they came here.
Sure.
That's where Nazism started.
Right. Safety first with the reindeers.
Right.
You guys take it easy.
That's it.
I want every elf check for a green card.
Shake them down. Shake every one of them down.
Yeah, metal detectors going in and out, and ID going in and out of that workshop.
Josh, you're on Ron and Fez. How you doing, buddy?
Hey, Josh.
Yeah.
Josh, go ahead, pal.
Are you there?
Yeah, we're here.
No, we left.
I got some information on how exactly they irradiate the mail, if you're interested.
Are we? That's all we can think about tonight.
They need 6 feet of concrete to shield the workers from the irradiation beams. So they have to build a separate room and run the mail through that.
All right, this is ridiculous, Fez. For fake letters to Santa?
We're building a room with 6 feet of cement?
Why don't we just tell the kids there's no Christmas this year? We're scared.
All right, guys, you're great. See ya.
Santa's too scared to come and see you kids.
So that guy was going to tell us how mail gets irradiated, but all he told us is they need really thick walls to protect postal workers from the laser beams.
Is it the laser beam? Perhaps.
877-692-1027.
Hey, David, you're on the Ron and Fez show. How you doing, buddy?
Hello, David.
How you doing?
Yeah.
What can we do for you, Biggin?
I just want to know if Santa runs a little bit off course, the F-16 is going to shoot him out of the sky.
Smart idea.
Yeah, they'll be ready.
Yeah. Actually, why not just have an F-16 on each side of them to protect them?
That would be nice.
And then if it looks like there's any trouble, they make him land.
But I don't see how he could deliver toys to the White House. You're not going to let anyone fly in that close.
No. Right. No, the Bush children get nothing but liquor this year. I heard if a reindeer blows out, it detaches safely from the reins. What does that mean, Joe? What are you trying to say?
Well, you can't have those reindeer on the sleigh with sharp antlers.
True.
No sharp objects. We've learned that.
What's the problem with just cutting off those things? You don't need a hat rack in this day and age.
Right. We're lopping off red noses and antlers right at the root.
Gene, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hi, Gene.
Yeah. Hi. I think Santa's got to be pretty careful about eating the milk and cookies that the kids will leave out.
Yeah.
Oh, you're not going to poison Santa this year.
Exactly. You know, maybe kids will just leave like a Mrs. Fields coupon or something like that.
There you go.
That could be dangerous.
Santa, what's wrong?
Arab cookies.
Oh, no. No unwrapped cookies for Santa this year.
Arab cookies.
Thank you, Jane. 877-692-1027.
Oh, it's insane, Fezzy. All the things we got to do. Hey, Manny, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, Manny.
Hey, guys.
Hey.
I just want to let you know that the New York City Central Post Office on 34th Street, when it was built just at the turn of the century, was the largest post office in the United States. So all those oddball letters to Santa with no address just automatically got sent there because they had more room.
So then, all these years, they just kept up to send them all to 34th Street?
And that fact was part of the premise that they built Miracle on 34th Street around.
You, my friend, should sit at the end of the bar in a mail costume.
Hey, what can I tell you?
All right, see
I'm a native New Yorker. I know my stuff.
I like it. All right, see you, buddy.
See you.
He's Mr. Christmas.
Hey, Steve. Steve, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hello, Steve.
First time caller.
Buddy.
How you doing?
Cool in the gang.
Listen, I was just going to say, what's it called? the first time caller was that the beginning of the movie Scrooge might be a reference for anti-terrorist activity around Christmas time.
Oh, that's true. Right. That's true.
We should have someone try to grab that.
They did that fake special on IBC, like terrorists take Santa's lair. And that was pretty
funny.
The
night the reindeer died.
That's right, exactly.
Not tonight.
Good show, guys.
All right, see you, buddy.
Talk to you later.
All right.
You're being a real good boy this year, Lee.
Lee Majors.
That's Lee Majors.
And his last appearance of any kind. Damn it, I got to watch it this year for Christmas.
This is one Santa who's going down fighting.
Hey, Chris. Chris, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hello, Chris.
Hey, what's going on, Ron and Fez? Just started listening to you guys when you switched to new time slot. Love your show.
Thanks, buddy.
Just wondering if Santa was going to have to worry about birds flying around Christmas time or if we're going to kill them all off before then.
Hopefully we'll have every bird dead by then.
Right.
Every single bird will be dead.
Also,
Rudolph knows he's going to be attracting them to him, you know? Slade's going to go down with one hit.
All right, man. Yeah, good point.
All right.
All the only bird Santa's going to have to worry about is the fattest goose in all of London.
Go get it for me. He did it all in one night.
Hey, Ken. Ken, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
Hi, Ken.
So pretend like Santa Claus has nunchucks. And so pretend like I'm fighting with Santa Claus. And then there's reindeer and Jim Shorts is there.
You're not the real Kenny Allen.
Yikes. We can tell the real annoying Kenny Allen.
I don't know what happened. He moved my Kenny Allen drop. Every night it's something different, Fezzy. Heckler. Heckler's calling us. How you doing, Heckler? Hey, Heckler.
Hey, Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas to you, buddy.
This is bringing back memories. When I was like 6 years old, my mom took me to this huge department store in downtown Brooklyn called A&S. And they had a winter wonderland with about 20 Santas in these big rooms.
Yeah.
And it was long lines in every room, but there was one room with no line. So my mother grabbed me. I was like, I guess 5 or 6. I went into this room. There was a Santa Claus. He was like Wilt Chamberlain, 7 feet tall, black, huge. And he looked at me and he just said, "Hey, boy, get in here." I screamed like a retard. I ran away. My mother grabbed me and said, "You will see Santa now." And I was dragged into the Wilt Chamberlain Santa Claus, crying, kicking, just freaking out over this big guy.
Is it because he was black, you think?
Just that he was scary. I guess being black, you know, he's 6 years old, 5 years old, you know, you want to see that jolly old man with the pink cheeks. And I got some 7-foot guy who, I mean, he literally looked like Wilt Chamberlain.
And what exactly did he say to you?
He said, "Hey, you get in here, get in here."
White people are so scared.
No, not a matter of fear. It's, you know, the innocence of being a child.
White people are so scared.
But I actually went in, he settled me down, and he gave me like 5 times the amount
of
candy.
Crack.
Well, I walked out of there with more candy than any other kid.
Maybe because he touched you. I think a black man touched you and you turned it into a Santa story as the years have gone by.
You're trying to remember him as Santa.
Now, don't go there with that. Come on. I mean, this was,
It happened. Live with it.
You want me to start crying on the air here? Yeah, this isn't like Sally, Jesse, Raphael. I'm just telling you about the big black Santa who traumatized me.
All right.
Now, I love big black Santa. I pray for big black Santa to come here and spread some joy. You know what I'm talking about?
All right. Thank you, buddy.
Merry Christmas.
Thank you, Heckler.
You know, we're trying to get into the situation, Fezzy.
Right.
That's a little frightening. Santa's in trouble this year.
Sure. Santa now affected by terrorism. All letters to Santa will be irradiated for anthrax.
Finally. I wish they would have done this 5 years ago.
Why don't they just do it to all the mail? Why just the letters to Santa?
That's a good point.
Why not just run them all through the laser beams?
Hey, Hector. Hector, you're Ron Fez.
Hey, how you doing, Ron Fez? BA card holder 4932. Listen, I got to tell you guys something. St. Nicholas, which was the origin of Santa Claus, came from Turkey. The country of
what?
Turkey. Yes.
Santa's from Turkey?
Yeah. St. Nicholas, which is...
That's why we eat turkey every year, Fez.
Ow!
From the country of Turkey, so... Oh, yeah, he Santa Claus is definitely an Arab.
Well, if he was
thought he was from Sombertown with the Burgermeister.
All right, if he was a saint, that's a Catholic saint, he probably wasn't an Arab.
Well, actually, no, you do have some Arab Catholics out there.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
I'd love to meet them.
Oh, yeah, just don't, just be careful what they put in the collection plate.
All right, thank you.
Later.
All right, so there it is. Maybe we better shake Santa down as well. Finn.
Sure.
Hey, Tom, you're on the Ron Fez Show.
Hey, Tom.
Hey, guys, what's going on?
Hey, buddy.
Hey, buddy.
Buddy? All right, enough of that.
Hey, I was just curious to know if Santa was going to attach a couple missiles and stuff like that.
Why not? Why not?
We could use them as a little decoy and then drop a couple smart bombs or whatever you want to do over there.
Yeah.
You know, instead of dropping some toys, a couple smart bombs.
Put some cruise missiles on the side of that sleigh.
All right, see you, buddy.
Bye.
Bye.
Brad, you're on Ron Fez.
Hello, Brad.
Hey, how you guys doing?
Yeah.
I'm just curious if you guys heard anything about the letters that are going to go to Hanukkah Harry and what's going to happen to those.
They're all going right through.
No problem.
Right through, huh?
Yeah. From what we've heard.
Take a shot. That's what they're saying. Take your best shot.
All right, man. I'll send it through.
All right.
I guess I could always have a decoy sleigh out there Christmas Eve.
Sure, why not?
Just something, flying around that's not Santa. A dummy Santa.
I say to the kids as nice as you can, you won't get any presents this year. We can't take the chance.
I guess you were just really bad. That they'll understand.
Then say you're getting a week off school. Why, bitch?
877-692-1027.
Hey, Bruce, you're on Ron Fez.
Hey, Bruce.
Boys, evening. I got a solution to the letter problem.
What's that?
Do you remember the annoying elf, Hermes, the one who wanted to be a dentist?
Oh, sure.
You just have him open all the letters.
Just send all that mail onto the Island of Misfit Toys.
Hermie doesn't like toys. He doesn't want to make toys.
Hermie doesn't like anthrax.
I want to be a dentist.
We have dolls that walk and talk and cry and have a temperature. But we don't have dolls with anthrax.
Why not get the kids some kind of little anthrax game, like a check game, like a doctor's kit, only they're checking for anthrax.
Oh, that's fun. Then you make it part of the holiday.
Please, Mom, can I please get an anthrax kit this year?
Only if you're really, really good.
Sweet Melissa would get one of those because she was interested in biology as a child. I go out there, Fezzy, she's reading some kind of weird magazine that you and I would look like two retards looking at. We'd look like the RCA dog staring at it sideways.
Some sort of Science Digest journal.
I tried to read it. It sounded like this.
The word should not have that many letters.
I said to her, I read something like that without pictures once. It was good. Then she was going, I'm very interested in how the brain works, and she's bringing up brain patterns and stuff.
Uh-huh.
And I go,
you got a great ass, you know that?
Oh, good.
Like a retard, I think.
Yeah.
And she's just like staring back at me.
Anybody ever tell you about your cans?
Maybe you should study up a little bit.
I tried.
Prepare for a conversation.
All I said is,
I know where babies come from.
Sweet Melissa's in the studio tonight.
Melissa, come on in, honey. What was that magazine you were reading?
That was a New Scientist.
What was the article about?
Well, that...
See if the Fez and I could understand.
Well, no, there's really good one, that recent studies have shown that even a little bit of coffee raises your heart, your risk of getting heart disease, like, tremendously. There's oils in it.
All right, what about cocaine?
They didn't do the study on that. It's in your
so good, then we don't have to... We don't so have
perfectly to be, safe.
And we don't have to get rid of it from the vending machine.
Excellent.
So coffee's not good for you?
They say even a little, like one cup of coffee is enough to raise your risk, like, a lot.
Really? What about iced coffee?
Anything with that's brewed and not filtered.
All right, what about this? What if you have coffee, but you put a lot of milk and sugar in it?
Oh, yeah.
Diluting
the counteract.
It. Yeah. Diluting it.
Counteracting. Cousin and I have come up with something.
Well, dilution doesn't seem to help either.
What if the coffee drinks have a really old, old expiration date?
That's just poison.
What about you put a lid on the top of it? Would that help you? Shield you?
No, I don't think so, Ron.
Sweet and low.
I was the degree.
Low death.
What's the degree that you got?
I have MS in toxicology, Master's of Science in Toxicology.
Really?
Yes.
Huh.
It's the science of poisons. So
Wow.
Yeah, it's really neat.
I forgot to tell you, I'm poison.
Poison ivy. Yeah. If something happens to you and you start to control the plants, we'll still be your friends. All right, so you're probably the smartest one here.
No.
You gotta be.
Hawk, did you...
You got the most diplomas.
Hawk, did you do any college?
Yeah, I went to college.
Did you finish?
Really?
Yep.
You sure you used to drive by one?
No, I actually graduated.
What's your degree in?
Communication.
That's great. Go get me another Coke, would you?
Yes, sir.
So you have a bachelor's?
Bachelor's, yep. Bachelor's of Art.
Arts. Of arts, yeah.
Of art.
A B.A.
I like art. He's a bachelor named Art. Joe, you went, what, half a semester at a community college?
Yeah, I finished up 3 years.
You still working on that GD?
I got a master's in wasting time and whacking off.
Why you got to start that? When you don't get dumped out already. You know that phrase doesn't get on. We told you that last night.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh, okay.
So you can't use anything off or job.
All right, I'll put that down.
Oh, jeez. Hey, it's WWF Fallon's birthday.
Oh, happy birthday, WWF Fallon.
From the message board. You talk to him, Melissa?
I talk to everyone on the message board. I'm friendly.
Who do you not like, though?
Who's the worst person?
Claire.
Oh, no, Claire's really beautiful.
You thought you weren't going to like Claire, and then you guys hit it off.
I was nervous about meeting Claire, because people told me stuff. Like, that she didn't like me.
Tell us one person who told you bad things.
About that Claire?
Yeah. G-back?
People at the bar crawl said that she was, you know, she was, you know, not saying, like, she would just make funny faces with like, my name and was, I wouldn't say.
She's not like that. She's kind of shy.
Yeah.
Standoffish.
Maybe it was another girl cutting herself.
Oh.
I think that's the only
not
one
Claire.
We have.
No.
But you guys hit it off when you met, right?
Yeah, I liked her. She didn't really say goodbye to me, but.
Well, that's her thing. She's, you know, she's in her own world.
That's fine. I felt really good next to her.
So you must be the smartest person on the message board, too.
Oh, they're okay. I would never.
Anybody got a master's in science on the message board?
Well, two kids working on it, remember? She wants to get her PhD.
Who would win in Jeopardy? You, Too Cute, and Hort King?
Hort King.
Do you think?
I don't know.
What's he have? Is he like a doctor or something?
Oh, isn't he working on being a psychiatrist?
I don't know. Whenever anyone starts to talk about their life, I just tune it out.
Yeah.
I like to get back to me.
Yeah. No, he's going to be a psychiatrist, so he's really smart. And he knows a lot about everything. Yeah.
Then he can get his meds.
I mean, I'm a failed scientist, so I don't know everything.
You were laughed out of the institute?
Oh, guess what? Now I guess we can say whacking off.
We can?
People writing to us that we can say whacking off. So I apologize to you for that.
Everything has changed.
And then also, from the commercials, there's a new phrase we can say.
Yeah.
I think it's stuffing in the ass.
Yeah. Stuff its ass.
Stuff its ass, we can say.
According to the new commercial copy.
Great.
Stuff its ass.
So that'll be, instead of see ya, stuff its ass.
Stuff its ass!
I hope Rory got a chance to see that, Al.
Yeah.
Showed to him before the show.
Right.
That the new phrase is stuff its ass.
We can say it all the time now.
Yeah.
Sweet Melissa, did you ever have, like, an experiment go horribly awry? Did you ever explode anything by accident?
I spilled boiling acid on myself.
No way!
That
yeah.
So hot. That's the hottest thing you ever said. Okay, where? On your ass.
Don't I wish. No, it was, I had this whole elaborate setup, and I flail. Like, I tend to...
Like an idiot.
Like an idiot. And yeah. I just knocked it all over.
You're like the absent-minded professor, Joe
yeah.
Lewis.
You might have
the acid burns.
You might have invented flubber.
Yeah.
Was anything bouncing
no.
when you came to?
No, I wasn't that fortunate.
Did lightning strike? You may have turned into the Flash.
No, I really was a bad lab student.
What were you good at? Now you're like a professor, right?
Yeah, I teach labs, so I run the labs for the young students. It's hot. They love it.
Me and my friend tried to make angel dust one time, and it didn't.
How'd that work out?
It was bad. All we did, we got this stuff from the Undertaker. We knew a guy that was an Undertaker.
Uh-huh.
So we got embalming fluid and poured that on, what the hell is the green stuff they used to for angel dust? It's like a household product. I don't know, it's like parsley or something like that, right? So we just poured it on that, rolled it up, and smoked it. Oh, my God. It's like I got hit in the head with a hammer. And I was going like that. Kind of works. Before that, we're thinking, we can sell this and become rich. So, that, you know, I have somewhat of a chemistry background. I had a chemistry set when I was younger. Did you have one of those, Fez?
I had one of those. Came with the microscope, too, where you could look at crap.
But my only thing I liked to do was to take the chemicals and pour them into puddles. And I thought maybe something would happen, mix them with the puddle water.
Something would just kind of fizz up out
right.
of some sort of creature.
And then, you know, I'd have a notebook with me. Interesting. So that's about as far as I got.
That's really cute.
So here's the weird thing. If we were all in school together, Melissa wouldn't even know us.
Oh, I know.
We would be the weirdos that are smoking parsley and embalming fluid. Write that down in case it's ever got to do a scientific paper.
I like that.
Not good. Don't smoke it. I call it embalming fluid and parsley. Don't smoke it.
Here's his study right here.
That's all I've got written so far. You fill in the rest.
I'll tell my students. They're like crazy college kids.
Do they ever try to make crystal meth or anything? Try to get, meth labs going?
Me, no, but maybe
some of the kids,
yeah,
do?
Probably, yeah. A lot of the chemists are also druggies. So.
Now, only a few people, I was reading this not too long ago, only a few people in the history of the country could even make LSD.
Really?
Yeah, and they were saying that there hasn't been an LSD lab busted in this country since, like, the 70s.
Wow.
Because these guys will move around and just make a bunch of it, and then they're... You know, gone like Kaiser Sose.
Sure.
Well, I guess if they're that smart, they know how to cover their tracks. You know,
they're crazy people. Look at Osley. He was a maniac.
Could you ever do cool experiments for us in here?
Like make us acid?
I don't think I could make it.
What could we do? What could be like, you could be like Miss Science and we could do that stuff.
Right.
We're just using household stuff.
Well, there is stuff that you can do that doesn't require, like, flame or anything. So I could...
What can we do?
We don't mind fire.
Oh, I thought we couldn't. Someone told me there are rules against all that.
F-L.
Remember, the rules just changed. We're saying stuff its ass tonight.
So we're allowed to do that now, Al?
And whacking off.
No, Rory says that that phrase is because they're talking about the turkey.
That's what we're talking about.
Yeah.
And that you do that to a turkey, so that's...
So, that's what... I mean, so we haven't been dumped tonight, right?
Right.
Because every time you hear us, we're talking about turkeys.
Right, just know that.
So bang it. That just really means take a hammer and bang a turkey.
Uh-huh.
All right, so what kind of chemistry stuff can we do?
Well, usually it's just transforming something so I can make pretty colors for you. I don't know what...
Wow,
I would love that.
I want to do that. I had the feeling... Any of my experiments required plenty of dry ice.
Oh, they're fun.
Yeah.
Just to make beakers and test tubes.
His,
foam and fizz.
Right. His science experiment was a Deep Purple tour in 1974. So could we make something like that happen?
Oh, definitely. I'll bring some utilities next time I come.
What's something that the students go nuts for if you show them an experiment?
A lot of.
What's your closer or opener?
It's usually an opener. That anything that you can get to fizz and like have it go so much that like it gets like out of control. They love anything that.
Let's do one of those out of control ones.
Yeah.
I usually pretend like, oh my gosh, it's like I didn't expect this to happen. You know, you sell it.
Everybody loves that. I bet they love you.
Sell it. Oh yeah, they flirt.
You ever been with a student?
Oh no, no. I treat them like my kids, I guess.
Wow.
But they flirt, though. It's bad. You can see them, like, they're trying to get the courage to ask me out, and it's, like, really uncomfortable.
Well, I would just...
How do you think we feel?
I would just foam something at them.
Well, there's not magic.
I'd pour some beakers and some test tubes together and just foam something. You ought to, like, close every class with just some big flash powder, and then you're gone.
That would be so cool.
She's not a magician. She's not working at Hogwarts.
It sounds like it.
See, the problem with you, Fezzy, like most pilgrims, you don't understand the difference between science and magic.
Mm.
You know, she does a nice magic experiment. You think she's a witch. This is pure science.
The more foam and smoke, the better.
All right, people writing this. What about if you use something to burn off Claire's clothes next time?
Oh, that's hot. Okay.
That would be hot.
Yeah, could you do that?
I don't think I could do it without hurting her.
I can do it
with a spray can and a lighter.
All right, Joe, you know why your experiment doesn't work, right?
Why?
People burn, too.
Yeah.
I've told you time and time again. People burn as well.
That only works in St. Elmo's fire.
Can I try it anyway?
With a dog.
Oh. Not Claire.
No, not Claire. We've told you time and time again.
What if she's holding a knife?
Well, you got to defend yourself.
She'll slice that aerosol can right out of your paw.
I hear Mike has some suggestions of some experiments that we can do. Hey, Mike, you're on the Ron and Fez show with our favorite scientist, Sweet Melissa. Hey, Mike.
Hey, guys. It's Mike, the science teacher.
How you doing, buddy?
Good. If Melissa could get hold of two things. Number one is liquid nitrogen. That's fantastic.
Yeah, we need that.
A good experiment is you take a racquetball and you dip it inside of it. And after about 30 seconds inside of that, if you take that racquetball out and hit it with a hammer, it'll shatter like it's made out of glass.
That I gotta say. That's so Terminator 2.
I could even bring... I don't know if I was the guy who was going to bring in the toast, but remember you said the open flames couldn't
do it?
Yeah,
crying about Pop-Tarts.
Right, exactly.
Yeah, we can't have a toaster in here.
Can you get your hands on liquid nitrogen?
I can't imagine that... I could, but I'll look around.
I'm a teacher. I just go to the place. It's tough because you have to buy a special thermos to keep it in because it's at minus 275 degrees.
Wow, don't mix that thermos up with your coffee.
Exactly.
All right, I'm going to put you on hold.
I also have one quick...
I have a thing. What if we put a squirrel in there?
Yeah.
I think we can shatter a squirrel with a hammer. That's my theory.
I got a great science lab story.
Yeah.
When I was doing my student teaching, I... was the lab assistant, like Melissa is, for a biology class of nurses. And what we do to show them cells is they scrape the... Maybe you did this with a toothpick. You scrape the inside of your mouth and you see the cells under that microscope.
Yes, I've done that.
Right, you know what I'm talking about, Melissa?
Of course.
Called the cheek epithelial cells. Well, we had a microscope set up and all the nurses were doing it. And this one nurse said, could you come over here? There's something swimming around in my slide. Think about what might have been swimming around after...
You found it in there?
There were little semen swimming around inside her mouth cheek self-scraping. And all the class...
You know, I don't think I like microscopic anything.
Yeah, I know.
One time,
gnarly.
I saw something about those little mites that live in your eyebrows.
That movie. They show that they look like giant monsters.
And I just kept scratching my face for like 2 years. I can't stand the thought... of eyebrow mites.
Ron, I am you about the liquid nitrogen.
Hold on, Mike.
Always.
Talk to him off the air, Al. Bore him off the air.
I used to pull my eyebrows out because I just didn't like hair. So I used to pull because of all the bugs I used to have.
So from studying, right?
Well,
And knowing they were in there.
Absolutely. I used to get phobic over bacteria and things.
A lot of crackheads get the same way. They just get so nervous.
Start tearing at themselves.
You want to weird out someone on coke, start talking about eyebrow mites.
Mm-hmm.
That's awful.
That's my other theory. Write that down. Get someone coked up and then keep talking about eyebrow mites, and I bet that they get freaked. That's my theory.
It's all going into this paper.
Yeah. I'd love to get a grant.
Oh, man.
What am I going to do to win one of those Nobel Peace Prizes or whatever? Is that the big one, Nobel?
Yeah. There's so much.
You can get that for chemistry. All right, what did the last chemistry person get theirs for?
Oh, which one was it? It just came out. Oh.
What did they do? I bet they didn't freeze a racquetball.
Damn, I don't remember.
I swear, if I was on that Nobel committee, I'd give it to Frozen Racquetball every year. Until someone could show me something better.
The winner again, Frozen Racquetball, shattered by hammer. So my theory is, if we freeze these, we never have to worry about racquetballs again. Where do you put your hand in that liquid?
Oh, yeah, you would shatter as well.
Oh, wow.
It's really very painful to get burned by liququid nitrogen. You have to wear special gloves and everything.
We're learning so much.
Now, if you stuck your hand in the liquid nitrogen, would your whole body freeze, or would it just work its way up the arm over just so far?
It would be where it's frozen, and then
it would be right to where it stops right where you're dipping.
Yeah, right up to the liquid part, and then it's not like the cartoons. you know when you freeze.
Yeah, right.
I know, we got to freeze a person like a Terminator.
I could listen to you talk about science all night if you were in a teabag jumping up and down on a trampoline. I would just listen.
Ron's doing so well in science.
I got a cram. Put on the teabag, get on the trampoline. We got to take a break. 877-692-1027.
We're Ron and Fez.
Ron and Fez. 1027. WNEW.
The Ron and Fez Show, Fezzy.
877-692-1027. Sweet Melissa's here tonight.
Hi.
Our sweet science teacher and Joe Poo is in the house.
Hello. Boy, it's like black and white, isn't it, Fez?
It really is.
It's like having the brightest person we know and the dumbest person.
I guess I'm the black one.
Yeah. Now, scientifically, would Joe be considered retarded?
Aww.
All right, we were talking about getting a Nobel Prize, right?
Yeah.
Al Dukes, come on in here. Who won the last Nobel Prize for chemistry?
I have no idea.
All right, but you know when it came up and you didn't look. Dan from Hoboken has sent it in. I'll have you come over and read this because...
I love it when instant feedback and calls beat the producers.
What exactly did this guy win for?
Knowles and Nayori... for their work on chirally catalyzed hydrogenation reactions. Basically, what that means is molecules can either turn light left or to the right, and that it depends on their chiral center. And they just were able to now figure out how to separate them in a better way. It's actually going to do great for science, but it's boring.
It's not boring. It's the kind of stuff I like to get Fez and I working on.
Sure.
Because I want to start spinning molecules.
Yeah, now what can we use that for? Now that they realize how to make them turn left and right.
They'll be our slaves.
Foolish molecules.
All right, Fez came up with a good point. What can we do with that? Now that we got it.
Okay, humans can only utilize one type of molecule. The amino acids especially, we only like one form of it.
Mm-hmm.
So now that when we make drugs or something, we can separate them much easier, and it's good for studying. But it's not really good for us as people.
Yes, it is. It's going to help us. It's going to help us explore other worlds, Fez.
Oh, nice. If you can use it in time travel, I'm all set.
Can we use that to blow stuff up? All right, will we ever have time travel?
I don't think so, but...
I do.
You know what I did hear is that a person could travel through a black hole and actually get to the other side.
We would survive it?
What they're saying is, yes, we would survive.
Here's what you're going to do. You're going to tuck in real tight. You're going to pull your knees all the way up to your chest.
Yeah, tuck your chin.
Lose a finger. All right, what happens?
But it would take an eternity.
But you'd be alive for eternity.
You physically wouldn't be able to, but your body would survive the trip.
Would we end up in the past?
They don't know that, Fezzy.
Would we end up in the past?
I think we should.
Would we end up in the past?
what, you think you're doing it, Fez?
Or just stuck?
All right, what about that thing on Star Trek where you're beaming places?
Oh, that's a good one.
Oh, that's neat.
Yeah. I like to do that for Fez for his travel plans.
See, that would be nice.
But that would be bad.
I don't know how wide they make those beams.
I can fit in a beam. It's a big circle, those Star Trekkers stand
on. What we'll do is just put two together and get in that way.
You will not need two.
Now that
because that's how many seats I have to buy on an airline.
We don't have the power to beam them.
Now that's a good one. Can we teleport? Now that we can make the molecules go which way we want to.
Let's get them in the triple XL beam.
Teleportation is a way off, I think. You know,
like
you
it's got to be like 5 years away.
They always say five. Yeah. You know, it was five in 90.
Right. So I mean, I think that we can first start doing it with monkeys. That's
right.
My dream.
Monkeys love to go first.
Will we ever get to an age where we'll make monkeys smarter?
I think they figured out that monkeys are very intelligent.
Right.
Dolphins are the most intelligent. They actually can recognize themselves in the mirror and know their self.
I don't know about the dolphins thing being smart because they don't have hands.
Right.
And if I was swimming around no hands and no legs, I would just keep bashing my head against a rock until I was dead.
How can a dolphin recognize itself in a mirror? It's not like there's mirrors out in the ocean.
Well, they set up a laboratory, Fezzy.
Yes, Fez. It's not done in the wild. Fez not. Sometimes I don't think Fez is as smart as you and I.
That dolphin couldn't figure itself out the first time it saw it, could it?
It realized it was looking at itself. I don't, you know, isn't that so random though? How would they even realize what it was thinking?
Well, I got a theory on animals.
Okay.
No pants, no brains. You're not smart enough to put on pants.
I've seen monkeys in suits and they're hysterical.
Was the dolphin staring in the mirror and saying, I'm smart, I'm beautiful, and damn it, people like me?
Joe, you want to just goof around or you want to learn a little something about science, okay? We can do the silly shows every day. Tonight, people like Melissa and I are trying to teach you something.
I feel like I'm forced into a classroom again.
Aww.
The last time that happened, you were in eighth grade.
That's true.
And that was last year.
And you were still saying to the kid next to you, shh, hey, write my name down for me at the top.
I did that every day. I'm doing experiments with my own poo. I didn't know we were going to have a test today.
By the way, we're sending sweet Melissa back and forth to Shooting Star Limousines, Fezzy.
Nice.
Shooting Star. Feel like a star in Shooting Star Limousines.
631-447-2727 if you want to check out a Shooting Star Limousine or any of their great specials.
We do that with all of our scientist guests.
Oh, thank you.
We have more than one?
Stephen Hawking loved it.
Oh, I would love to get you and Stephen Hawking together. Oh. You know what? I would love for you and Stephen Hawking to have a baby, and then for me to take it and raise it to really do something good.
To rule you would the take world.
You would take my baby
for scientific
me.
Purposes.
That's awful.
All right, let me throw this one out to you, sweet
Just
Melissa.
Just give me your eggs.
Invisibility. I saw the movie Hollow Man.
Yes.
And in that movie, they actually say, oh, when we started our research, turning things invisible was no big problem. We did that quickly. It was bringing them back that we had the problem.
Right.
That got me so excited when they said, invisibility's easy.
Here's the problem. I can get people invisible, but they get angry once they're there and get crazy.
Just furious about being invisible. I don't get it.
I love the way they sum up science in movies. It makes me so mad.
I know. They seem like they get it quick. It seems like the guy is just sitting in front of a computer pulling his hair for a while. I've been working on this for 2 days.
As long as they talk nice to their computers.
And then, you ever notice this? They think because those people are smart, their computers are like some kind of 3D cool thing to have. It's like, oh, all right, I'm inside. And you just see you're looking at neutrons for some reason on the computer.
Yeah. They push one button. They push enter.
Yeah.
And, you know, DNA is unraveling in front of you.
Sorry. That is just so ludicrous. It makes me, I can't watch those movies.
Did you watch Hollow Man?
I watched Hollow Man and I.
Did you love it?
No. I'm sorry.
No offense. No one loved it. Even Kevin Bacon was ashamed of that movie. Here's what you don't understand, maybe because you're not as smart as Melissa and me, is that you don't understand
that must be it.
How many years that we have studied this stuff, and we only know a little bit.
How many years have you studied?
Between the two of us?
No, just you.
It doesn't matter. We're a team with this.
Hmm.
He gets so jealous. He gets so jealous when I have somebody in my own IQ to hang around with.
It's hard.
Yes,
you have to have patience.
Yeah,
for
Joe
him.
Pooh's there tonight.
The magician of Menlo.
I know, that would have been the time to be around.
Mm-hmm.
In like the 1800s, where you could just invent things easily.
Yeah, you invent a match, you're set for life.
Oh, I know. A phone. A phonograph. And then he just came. He did all these things. They're just spinoffs.
Right. All that stuff's easy to invent. Now, the only stuff left to invent is the really hard, impossible stuff like invisibility and teleportation.
And how about the Ford that folds into a briefcase?
Joe,
I want one. What would be so hard to
I might send you out in the hall tonight.
The hallway?
I'm going to send you out in the stupid Billy Staples room.
Someone's going to have to go get food. Because apparently we're doing an all-nighter.
Now I'm thinking cheesesteak.
Mmm. That sounds good. Al's talking about him during the break.
Yeah, Al's smart. All right, let's. Some of these people want to talk science with us.
Oh, I'm going to try.
All right, well, whatever you can't answer, I'll pick up. Okay. It'll be that easy. I love a hot chick who knows science. You know what I would do if I was your lab partner? I'd make you put your hair up and wear glasses.
I do that.
And then one night I would just have you take them off and you're beautiful. And then I would bang you on the lab table and then, I don't know, then I guess I would turn crazy after I turned invisible.
Well, something would spill at that point.
Yeah. You know what? Here's the way that I would be like Kevin Bacon, though. If we were working on something, I'd jab it into my own arm in a heartbeat. If I even thought, hey, there's a possibility this could be work, you'd look over and it'll be stuck in my arm. No!
That's not ready yet!
I am hideous!
I always wanted love potion. Oh, I always wish that could work, you know.
You are a love potion,
oh,
damn it.
No.
All right, here's Willie. Willie, you're on our Runifest.
Hello, Willie.
Hey, guys. Love the show.
Thanks, buddy.
Yeah, I was reading about 6 months ago that scientists for years thought that the speed of light was the fastest speed attainable, but they've discovered a speed that's faster. And to put it in terms, if you took a train from New York to Philly going at that speed, you'd arrive 30 minutes before you left.
Nice.
I would love to get on that train.
And like the way they describe it is, if you think of the speed of light or anything as like throwing a ball speed, this is like think of this as like a wave. So it's that fast, it actually bends physics, and they think it could lead to time travel.
You know,
And Melissa sounds really hot.
She is really hot.
All right, well, then that's verified.
All right, thanks a lot. So what do you think
of this? We have scientific evidence.
This new thing faster than the speed of light. I guess it's warp travel is what we're talking about here, Fuzz.
The warp train.
Well, I know if you travel, like, in a circle, there's something about traveling elliptically, and then you can end up where... But
Let me just say this. Fez doesn't understand the term elliptically. Why don't we explain that to him?
It's like...
I know what that means.
Go ahead.
Well, it's almost like a circle, but not.
Right.
You read the stuff, your brain turns to drivel because they talk in circles and it doesn't make sense. I know there's a physicist out there that could probably explain it better, but...
All I've ever wanted to do is travel faster than light.
That'd be so nice, you know, to arrive before you left.
Right.
So that when you're leaving, you can say, all right, see you yesterday.
Well, I could always get what I forgot.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I always forget my toothbrush. Or
right,
so
sure. I would be afraid that I would travel that fast. I would leave for vacation, but by the time I got there, I was due for work yesterday.
Oh.
I don't know if I'd be worried I'd get fired.
Right.
It's tough.
Yeah, sure. You kidding me? All right, here's Rich.
Hi, Rich.
Rich, you're on Rana Fez.
How you doing, guys?
Calling a gang.
Cardholder 4563. You guys were talking about teleportation?
Yeah.
I think it's either Bell Labs or... some scientist in Sweden or something.
Yeah, it's a guy in Sweden. Go ahead.
He's been able to transport a photon that's like a unit of light.
Yes.
He transported it across the room.
Matter of fact, it's called a flashlight.
Yeah.
And you just hit it and it shows up on the wall. I came up with that a couple years ago.
But all the way across the room.
It's just the storage and of all the cells and molecules.
In light?
Computer power. Yeah. The computer power
doesn't make sense, does it?
No. Are you a scientist?
No.
All right.
He loves weed.
He loves comic books and he smokes pot.
Well, that's cute.
Does Aquaman eat fish?
Sure. Starving. Tonight he would.
Gotta eat something.
If he's as hungry as me and Fez tonight, he would. All right, so that's crazy talk. We're going to do an experiment in here one night and blow something up.
Yeah, something good.
I'll figure out something.
Did you get
really
burnt by the acid?
It really hurt, but I'm okay. No scar.
Here's Dave. Dave, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hello, Dave.
Hey, what's up, guys?
Yeah.
Hey, listen, Ron.
Yeah, buddy.
If you did that thing to Melissa on the lab, there'll be probably still more acid on her.
That's no problem with me.
Listen, I got an idea for that chemistry experiment you want.
Okay.
You want to blow something up?
That's all we want to do.
All right, excellent.
What do you got, Dave?
Take a piece of pure sodium, the element, drop it in a cup of water.
Yeah, big explosion, that's for sure.
Big boom.
Is that a good one?
That's a great explosion, but it's very hard to get pure sodium and to transport it.
So much of the sodium is cut nowadays. They're stepping on it. They're stepping on it down in Miami. By the time it gets to New York,
they're cutting it with chloride.
Yeah, and, baby laxative.
Yeah,
my kingdom for some pure sodium.
Yeah, you're not kidding.
Right, how big of an explosion would it be?
It's pretty fantastic.
I would love to do that.
Yellow and big. It's really.
That's just one little drop.
Yeah, it's enough. It's pretty.
And would water go shooting all over the room or?
It goes. Like,
is it a fire explosion or just a big burst of smoke?
You'll have fire. Actually, sodium reacts with oxygen and explodes. So water causes it to fizzle like that.
Would it be the more water, the bigger the explosion?
The more sodium.
More sodium.
Yeah. And if it's a good ratio, it's pretty scary.
You know what I haven't played with in a long time that I always loved? And I would love to have a bucket full of this mercury.
Oh, amen.
Oh.
What's the most mercury you ever played with?
Oh, it was enough. It was like a big pile.
Oh,
of
I
it.
Never had one that big.
It was nice. It was really cool. We broke some stuff in lab, and I was playing with it because why not? And you can really clean your coins. I collect coins.
Yeah.
So you can clean your coins really nicely with them.
You collect coins.
Are you getting those state quarters? Because I am.
Oh, of course.
Yeah, right. Fez, all the serious coin collectors are waiting one by one for those state quarters.
I got the proof set with the silver. It's nice.
Really?
Yeah, I order it from the mint directly. And
I get some out of the soda machine.
I'm kind of hardcore.
Hey, Dave, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, how you doing?
We're okay.
All right. Hey, first-time caller, long-time listener.
Thanks, buddy.
The thing is, I'm thinking about this with Einstein's theory, E=mc².
Yes.
Okay, there's the problem with
this. I came up with something. I said that E=mc². And I believe I'm correct.
Well, he never equated gravity into this. You got to get over gravity before you can do anything else.
K-Pak said that Einstein was just misunderstood. That he really didn't know what he was talking about. People just didn't understand him.
He didn't know or he did know?
He did know what he was talking about.
Right.
So when people say Einstein was wrong about things, they're like, K-Pak is like, you're not listening to what Einstein was saying.
The only thing I really thought he was wrong about was his hair, the way he's wearing his hair.
That didn't work in any age or generation.
Here's the thing, conditioner.
Invent some of that.
We already have it. Rub it in your hair.
The equation actually should be E/g = mc².
I mean, I see your point, but he was doing that in empty space, like in a vacuum.
That's when these scientists come up with stuff, they're always looking for that. They're not saying at your house.
Right, but we don't
People
live
like
in
me and I, yes, we do.
We don't live in an empty vacuum.
I do. You should see my apartment. It's hideous. I'm living in an empty vacuum right now, Fez, and spending $4,000 a month.
Where are you vacuuming?
I would like
empty.
To see an empty vacuum go through that place.
Finally.
Sweep up a little.
I'm collecting eyebrow mites.
I just wanted to throw my two in on it.
All right.
Okay.
All right, thanks a lot.
Bye-bye.
My people don't get people like you and me and Einstein and little Stephen Hawking.
I mean,
little Stephen Hawking.
He's tiny.
You ever see his wife? Good looking.
The no one? How'd this guy cheat on his wife? That's what I love. The guy literally can't move nothing, and he cheats on his wife. That's got to be a theory somewhere. The guys are dogs.
I know. What's he saying? I'm going out?
On which
no, you're not. You're not moving.
No.
It's not what you think.
I think they gave him a new...
Trust me, I'm not thinking it.
British accent.
Shameless. I only know him from that movie.
Mm-hmm.
What was that movie called?
I don't remember.
Smoke two joints and go to it. That's all I'm saying about that Stephen Hawking thing. And it starts with a close-up of a chicken.
Oh, nice.
I was just like, this is great. we got one of those MP3 players to give away.
That's right. A Samsung Yep MP3 player. Visit the new Samsung store at the CompUSA location in Manhattan at 425th Avenue.
Actually, I would give one to any dolphin that can dial a phone if they're so smart.
They're
I
smart,
never fell for the dolphins are smart thing.
They are.
And I'm also saying this, the fish.
What makes them so smart? What do they do so smart?
They just seem to understand things
they're
on
idiots.
A higher level.
I never see one dancing with an organ grinder.
Here's the thing about them. They got a hole in the top of their head. How smart's that?
The brains have got to be leaking out.
They are idiots. And get this through your mind. If you live in the water and you got a hole in your head and you got flippers, you, my friend, are a fish.
I don't know, Ronnie.
You are not a mammal.
All right, and here's
they
the thing.
Might laugh me out of the institute for this, but dolphins are fish.
And how many of the swimming geniuses does it take to get caught in a tuna net before the rest of them realize, hey, stay clear of tuna. They're
right.
Bad news.
Well, just because their vision doesn't allow them to see the nets and fezzy doesn't mean they're dumb. Well,
but they know there's tuna around.
Won't they use their sonar?
Yeah.
My other theory is they use
like
sonar.
Like swimming bats.
They use sonar. That's my new theory. Their fish was sonar. I'd love to go down to SeaWorld. Wait, hold on.
I dropped some sodium right in that big whale tank.
Hi, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, I'm a dolphin and I dialed the phone. What are you laughing at? You think it was easy?
All right, you got to swim down here and then we'll give you your prize. You got to be an actual dolphin.
And not a Miami dolphin.
Let me, Fez, what do you think? Fish or mammal? Dolphin.
A dolphin.
Lives in the water.
Right.
It eats other fish.
Yeah.
Other fish.
Yeah.
Flippers.
Mm-hmm.
Fins.
Yeah.
That's a fish.
It's a fish-like mammal.
Let me ask you this. Where do you see them? SeaWorld? Aquariums?
Uh-huh.
They're fish.
Probably not going to see them outside an aquarium.
Joe Poole, what are they?
I like to refer to them as fishmen.
Thank you.
Fishmen.
I'll accept fishmen. At least it's closer to what I'm trying to get. A flat fish. That's it. And I would like to be able to catch them on a hook and eat them. Why are they so protected?
I should dissect one for you in here, and then you'll see. You'll understand more.
Why?
Because they're just physiologically different.
No.
No?
They're
Am
fish.
I wrong here?
Do they have breasts?
No.
Fish don't have breasts,
well, they
obviously.
Should, they should have something, like, because they have to have some sort of lactation device, but I don't know how.
Do they nurse their young?
I don't know that. I'm not a marine biologist.
Do they have pants?
No, you know they don't have pants.
If they did, they would be human.
You're an idiot, Joe. Would you please leave this to the scientists, me, Fez, and Melissa? All right? Because here's the problem. Melissa sees you. She's going to equate that with me and Fezzy being stupid, and we ain't. You've heard enough of that.
You guys are smart.
Thank you.
Hold
and
on,
soon the world will recognize it.
we got to take a break. 877-692-1027. Ron and Fez show.
We're Ron and Fez. 877-692-1027 is the toll-free phone number.
Just hanging out tonight. Last night we did the Michael Jackson big-ass simulcast. MP3 players, Fezzy.
We'll have one of those to give out later on tonight. A Samsung Yep MP3 player. You can visit the new Samsung store at the CompUSA location in Manhattan. That's at 425th Avenue.
Also, one on the RonFez.net football pool. We'll give out one of those this week if you'd like to go to that play. Just head on over to RonFez.net. Pick your favorite teams. Maybe you'll win the thing.
Yeah, win the football pool. Win a Samsung Yep MP3 player.
Albert, who won the trip last week?
Get the fabulous Al Dukes.
Yo, I'm cool.
us.
Yes. We know that,
yes,
Fonzie.
We know.
We're well aware
You're
of that, Fonzie.
Mundo.
But who won the trip?
No, that was the guy's screen name on ronfez.net.
Yo, I'm cool?
Yo, I'm cool.
I don't know him. Way to go, yo.
Yo, you are cool.
I thought maybe we'd give away one of these MP3 players, too, to maybe we'll put together a parody song contest.
Oh, okay.
Al and Billy are working on that, on all the rules and regulations, and maybe we'll announce that. And we're always looking for a good parody song guy.
Constantly. The search never ends.
Joe Pooh occasionally tries.
Right. He'll sing.
Airsick does some stuff.
Right. And, of course, Kimmy Gibbler.
Oh, boy, Kimmy Gibbler.
So, but we're always looking for a good parody song person.
Sure. How hard could it be?
Right.
In New York City, you think you'd be able to find somebody who can really do parody songs.
And you may just pick up an MP3 player while you're at it. Also tonight, we have movie passes to give away for 20th Century Fox's Shallow Hal, starring Jack Black and Gwyneth Paltrow. Also, for a sneak screening of 20th Century Fox's new release, Black Knight, starring Martin Lawrence. That's going to open nationwide Wednesday the 21st. You can see it first on Tuesday the 20th at the Village East Cinema.
All right, Fez, on the instant feedback here, here's an interesting question. Ron, can you ask sweet Melissa if her feet are ticklish? I'm a 6-foot blonde 23-year-old girl with a wild fetish for young girls' sexy feet. I just love her laugh and would love to suck her toes.
When can you come in?
Has anyone ever done that? You like to have your toes sucked?
I don't mind.
Do you have a foot thing? Let's see your little foot.
You want to see my foot?
Yeah.
I hope they're not.
That's good. Most women won't even shed the shoes.
Right. A lot of women panic.
Right.
You know, a lot of women we know, strippers, stuff like that, won't show their feet. You got great feet, right, though.
I don't know.
You got tiny little feet, though, huh?
Yeah.
No, you're not ticklish at all?
Not in the feet. That's not where I'm ticklish.
Can you put that up on the console?
Sure, I'm sorry.
Oh, that's a great foot.
Does you roll a little foot fetishy?
Is it all right? I mean, I'm sorry. I showed you my stuff.
That's just like showing one of the other girls.
You have excellent feet.
They're kind of like, you know, I was in high heels, so they get...
What size foot?
Size 6.
6.
Yeah.
That's a perfect foot, Fez. That's a perfect foot. All right, Jamie, if you really are a 6-foot tall woman, we would invite you in. Now,
right.
Fez and I have a buddy with a foot fetish. Nothing else in a woman interests him but the feet.
Yeah.
That's kind of creepy.
Isn't that strange?
Yeah, I'd like him to pay attention to everything.
All he wants is the feet.
Yeah, he can't get beyond it.
That's really creepy.
I think you could lop off the feet and he would be happy. Aww. He'd just go home with them.
Now, me, I'll do the dogs if that gets me other places.
Sure. Okay.
Like anything.
Right.
You know, I'll go meet your parents if that gets me other places.
But you have good feet. Your feet are the anti-Joe Pooh feet.
Yeah. I brought him some antifungal cream.
Did you really?
Yeah.
That you brewed in your lab?
Right now he's doing pro-fungal cream, so I don't think it's going to help.
It's an experiment I'm trying.
He's actually throwing algae in his shoes.
Hey, Joe, how's things working out with you and that new girl?
Oh, good.
Did you finally close the deal? You don't want to tell us?
Yeah, kinda.
Kinda?
Kinda.
Kinda.
What's that mean? You did, but she didn't?
Yeah, basically.
I hope she didn't have a foot fetish.
Or she was passed out.
That works.
That's horrendous.
They're not judgmental when they're passed out.
What is that up in the sky, Fuzzy? It looks like it's a broom.
It really does.
Is that a flying broom?
I think it is.
Oh, my God. Look who's coming in. It's the new kid's favorite. Later day, Harry Potter.
Hello. It's me, Harry Potter.
Hi, Harry.
Hello.
I'm just wild about Harry Potter.
Harry Potter, of course, the new wizard. We're going to do some Harry Potter trivia with you with later day Harry Potter here. Give us a call. We'll give out movie passes.
Give us a call, 877-692-1027.
877-692-1027. Harry, are you excited about your new movie?
I'm very excited about my new movie.
It's called Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone, and it's magical.
It's what?
Magical.
It really is.
Magical. That's British he talks, Fez.
Ah, okay.
Now, who are those friends that you hang around with there, Harry?
Oh, me friends. Oh, those are me good friends.
Yes, they're your good friends.
Very good friends.
They're going to be very famous too, Fez.
Right, yeah. They're all going to be famous after this movie's release. What are their names again?
Oh, Bob Cratchit.
No, it's not. That's from a different place.
Not Bob Cratchit.
But he's a good friend, too. I have many friends.
I'm not sure, but I think Harry Potter's a big girl. Does it when you hear him?
Not a big girl.
It sounds a lot like Mrs. Doubtfire.
Right.
I know her. She's a good friend of mine.
Moin?
Moin!
Always put an O in mind, and you sound British.
You sure do. So, you know, just so you're Harry Potter, your later years Harry Potter, you know everything.
Hello, I'm Harry Potter.
Now, what is that head wizard's name that runs the school that you're in?
Oh, yeah, the headmaster.
Oh, his name is Grendel.
I thought it was Dumbledore.
Yeah, that's right, that's right. I get them two mixed up.
You thought it was Grendel, of
Grendel course. From Beowulf.
I didn't watch a lot of Beowulf.
No, uh-uh.
By that, are you also meaning Baywatch? Is that how confused you are, Harry?
That's what happened.
All right, we're going to give
that's
some...
That's Jasmine Bleeth from Baywatch.
A chance to win some of these tickets. Here's Brian. Brian, you a big Harry Potter fan?
Brian?
Hey, how's going on, dude?
Hey, you a big Harry Potter fan? Have you read the books?
Not really.
All right, so you're just as good as the real Harry Potter in here.
Sure.
If you get a chance to win some movie tickets for this week, Harry, ask him a question.
The word... Azkaban refers to A. A wizard lucky charm, B. A prison for wizards, C. Country we believe Osama bin Laden is currently hiding in.
That would be Azkaban, huh?
Azkaban.
Yeah. Azkaban.
Azkaban.
Could you understand at all, Brian?
All right, so you got a multiple choice there.
Uh-huh.
Go ahead and give him the multiple choice again.
It's A. A wizard lucky charm, B. A prison for wizards, or C, country we believe Osama bin Laden is currently hiding in.
I'm going to go out on a limb and say B.
You were right.
Nice.
B, a prison for wizards.
Right, because and then he puts the O in the right sound. All right, so that's a lucky winner. Not near as fun as last night, huh?
No, uh-uh. Yeah.
It's funny, same questions, everything's there.
Right.
Not working as well, though.
What's different?
Maybe we're just tired of someone who won't work hard enough.
You're putting Harry in a bad mood.
Hey, Carl, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, Ron, Fez, Harry, how you doing?
Good.
Carl, you going to go see the Harry Potter movie on Friday?
Yeah. Hopefully with free passes.
Well, these free passes are for Shallow Hal and Black Knight.
It's a whole...
Shallow Hal I'd love to see, too.
Yeah,
okay.
Sure, who wouldn't?
Diagon Alley.
What?
Diagon Alley.
Diagon Alley, yes.
Is a place where wizards and witches can what? A. Shop for supplies.
A. Oh, sorry. Go.
B. Lose their powers forever.
Oh.
C. Score some crack and find witch hoes.
Oh, I wish it were C, but I'm sure you do too, but it was A.
Right.
All right, so I guess you read the books, huh, Carl?
Yeah. Big nerd.
Yes, you are. All right, Carl. All right, everybody's beating Harry Potter tonight.
That's right. They're going right up against the wizard.
These are very tough ones for me.
Yeah.
The later years boy wizard.
Not very amusing either.
Thank you.
The jokes are there, Fuzzy. It's the delivery, I say.
Yeah, that's probably what it's coming down to.
Sure, blame Harry.
Yes. We blame Harry.
Who else would we blame?
Since he's the one doing it, that's who we blame. Frank, you're on with Harry Potter.
Hey, what's going on, guys?
Say hi, Harry.
Hello.
Hey, Harry, what's up?
Is it not working for you?
What's that kind of candy that you eat again, Harry?
Candy canes.
No, it's not.
No, you don't eat candy canes.
Chocolate?
No. There's a chocolate frog. I saw that on the commercial.
Oh, that sounds good.
Yeah, well, not when it jumps. Frank, here's your question from Harry Potter. Everybody loves Harry Potter.
Hey.
Gringotts is the name of... That's Gringotts.
All right, Gringotts.
A, the wizard's bunk. B, the wizard's non-beauty salon. Or C, the white wizards that venture into the Mexican wizard's part of town.
Oh, brother, I'll go with A.
You were right.
All right.
Everybody's
Ringo,
right.
The Wizard's Bank.
Everybody
the
wins
bank,
with Harry.
Not bunk.
Bunk.
Bank.
Right, hold on.
It's not their bed.
I thought there was people sleeping there.
You like to make fun of me accent?
Oh, because he said Maeve, has he? That makes him British. I thought we were going to get some time out of this. No way. Let's scramble.
No, uh-uh.
Let's scramble.
Ooh, yeah. There I go back on me broom.
Here's Leo. Leo, you're on Ron Fez. How you doing, Leo?
Hi, Leo.
Hey, guys. 605. Hey, where'd Joe Poole go all of a sudden?
Joe had to run outside.
Right.
And he'll be on a broom later with Harry Potter and on intel to Hogwarts Express train, number 9.
That was a ship.
Yeah, last night it was a ship.
Right, now it's a train.
Anyway.
Yes, Harry Potter, yes. Later years.
Here's, I would laugh, except for it's dragging our show down. Now, if it was his show, hey, I'd be screaming.
You want to come drag down me movie?
What's he saying, Fez?
I said it about me movie.
I'm sorry.
All right, yep. Here you go, Leo. Go ahead, ask the question.
Platform 9 3/4 is where A, Harry is born, B, Harry boards the Hogwarts Express, or C, Harry meets guys and earns extra money.
What, Fez?
What was the question again?
Yeah, let's,
Platform 9 3/4? 9 3/4 is where A, Harry is born, B, Harry boards the Hogwarts Express, or C, Harry meets guys and earns extra money.
That C never sounds like it's the one. I don't know. I think it's B.
Right.
All right, correct.
You're not getting past anybody tonight.
You're not fooling anyone.
All right, go Bill.
And, all right, hold on for your tickets. And I don't see us getting a single laugh with this, Fez.
We're laughing inside.
In what?
Inside.
Oh, there's an owl inside.
Soid.
When's the movie open there, Harry?
I believe Friday.
When?
Friday.
Friday.
Is that right, Dame Edna?
Yeah. I don't know, maybe.
And what's the little girlfriend of yours name on the...
Oh, yeah, she's cute. That Ooh. Little girl that you got to go to school with at Hogwarts.
You mean the Queen Mum?
No, the little girl who's your best friend.
Oh, I forget her name. Do you know it?
Yes, I do. I was checking to see if you did.
I think in the later years, Harry Potter actually has some Alzheimer's.
Right, that's the problem with Harry.
Yes, me does.
Me does.
Me does have me Alzheimer's.
All right. Bye, Harry.
Bye.
Ho, 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 it's magic.
He's magic, Fez.
He certainly is.
That's all the song we have.
Ho, 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 it's magic.
Bye, Harry.
Bye.
There he goes.
Flying off with a broomstick.
Higher and higher. Bye, Harry.
Bye.
Bye-bye now.
There he goes.
What's that?
See you later, mates.
See you later, mates. Is that it?
See you later, mate.
Oh, he's coming back around again. Harry, how are you?
He's circling
Hello.
Us.
Hey, I'm going around the building.
What?
Can you hear me? I'm around the building.
He's around the building.
That's amazing. Shooting Star Limousines. They take our sweet Melissa back and forth tonight, Fuzzy. She only travels in the best.
If you want to... Hitch yourself to a Shooting Star Limousine, 631-447-2727. Shooting Star, they are the competition.
If you want to live like Puff Daddy or Sweet Melissa, Shooting Star Limousine, 631-447-2727.
You want to live like Harry Potter later years? Grab a broom.
He's coming back, folks.
Oh, no.
Hey, I'm back for being in the bucket of beer.
So awful. And not funny.
What did he forget that he's back?
I forgot me train tickets. There I go again.
All right, this on the instant feedback. He sounds like an imitation of the crocodile hunter if he got his nuts chopped off. Right.
Yeah, Harry Potter's not Australian, is he?
All right, Jamie wrote back to you and said, I would love to come down there only if she will let me have my way with her feet.
Wow.
But please do not make me come down there for nothing. Friday is great for me, if possible. I would love to bring my friend with me to take care of the other foot. Thanks, guys.
You're going to have to call us, Jamie, so we can make sure that you're a real woman.
Right.
Because normally only men have foot fetishes.
Yeah, when we start hearing, I'm a beautiful 6-foot blonde.
Right. We get the feeling that you're a beautiful 6-foot blonde guy. And that friend is you. Oh, yeah, she'll be up, but she wanted me to work on the foot first.
Yeah, I was supposed to meet some feet here. My beautiful blonde girlfriend is coming later.
Scary.
Well, that's our life, honey.
One scary moment after another.
It ain't all limos and Learjets for us like it is for you. 877-692-1027. Ron and Fez Show.
Ron and Fez. 1027 WNEW.
Thanksgiving is the time to grab a turkey, cut off its head, and stuff its ass.
Stuff its ass.
Stuff its ass. But at Neil Toyota in Lynbrook, Thanksgiving is the time to grab a new 2001 or 2002 Toyota, cut down the prices, and kick ass on the competition.
Now, if you're in Nassau County, Queens, the entire South Shore, you're just minutes away from the guaranteed lowest prices on hundreds of new ass-kicking 2001, 2002 Toyotas.
Neil Toyota has over 500 factory-certified pre-owned cars, trucks, and vans that spank the competition like a pantsless pilgrim in the town stockade.
Grab your Plymouth Rocks at Neil Toyota. Everybody's credit is approved, guaranteed.
Give him a call, 888-331-6424 for Neil Toyota.
All roads lead to Neil Toyota. In Lynbrook, on Merrick Road, just 10 minutes away from Queens, in South State, South Shore, Long Island, LIE, or Sunrise Highway.
Open 7 days a week. Give them a call, 888-331-6424. That's 888-331-6424 for Neil Toyota. Bow your head and give thanks. Neil Toyota kicks ass. Stuff its ass.
Stuff its ass.
Ron and Fez.
You're scaring me. Stop it.
1027 WNEW.
We're Ron and Fez. I 1027 WNEW.
It is the Ron and Fez Show. Sweet Melissa hanging with us tonight, Fez.
Hi.
Hello, Sweet Melissa.
I don't know whether we're going to have Sweet Melissa do any of her Sweet Melissa lines tonight, Fez, but we are cutting some promos with her.
Right. The new promos.
We're excited about them.
So we'll be in the studio. We'll be doing some studio work.
It's studio work.
We're getting back in the studio is what we're doing.
We have to do with her after the show.
Right.
Alright, we'll let him have one, Melissa.
Oh, you don't know how bad I need it.
Oh, God. Where's Al at tonight?
I haven't seen Al all night. Not whatsoever.
He's just useless, Fez. A lot of times I think that maybe he's anthraxed up. But I can never tell.
Anthrax would be a good thing. That would get him moving, at least. Now, speaking of anthrax and the terrorism and the precautions everyone has to take, situation on a flight, Ronnie, going from Pittsburgh to Reagan National Airport in Washington, D.C., they actactually had to stop and land at Dulles International Airport in Washington after a passenger got up and broke the 30-minute bathroom rule.
He's sitting on the john for 30 minutes?
Well, that's what I would think.
What the hell is he doing in there?
Get out of there. You're stinking up the joint. What happened was they have a rule of planes flying into national airport that you cannot get out of your seat the last half hour of the flight. So that half-hour approach into national, you're not allowed up. With 15 minutes left in the flight, he's heading down the aisle towards the cockpit just to go to the bathroom.
The guy's got to go to the bathroom.
So plainclothes sky marshals draw guns, tell him to get down on the floor and start handcuffing him. And he gets arrested after the flight.
People are just too freaked out to fly now.
Yeah.
Go before you leave. Are they even serving food on flights now?
I hope so.
I don't think they are. Because they don't want anybody in the aisle. They don't want anybody with a spoon or a fork.
I drink so much water getting ready to get on a plane. that I just cannot hold. I usually go like 3 times at the minimum on a flight.
Yeah, you're going to look like you're in there putting a bomb together.
I know. I'm going to look like I'm casing, you know, how to get into the cockpit.
Put some Depends on and just sit there and whiz yourself.
Oh, I think the whizzing myself will handle itself this flight.
I'm not a terrorist. I'm just a pussy. I'm fine.
I just have a small bladder.
It's a case of the nerves.
I'm going to have to get a note from a doctor.
Right. This kid's an idiot.
Saying, oh, please let him get up and use the restroom.
All right, let's do another Sweet Melissa line, because people keep writing in and asking for him. Go ahead. No, I want you to do one. Do one of your own.
I was just going to do something like...
Okay.
Just be careful. I don't want it to hurt too much, please.
God. She's perfect at those. So these are our new promos. We're going to cut some of them and hand them over to Jeremy. And, you know, for him, it ain't going to matter. But for us, we'll love them.
Sure. And then he can decide on
it. For him, it'll sound yucky.
Right now, all we're doing is turkeys getting their asses stuffed.
Which he loves.
Well, Ron, I promise I'll never tell. Wait, let me just take off my panties, okay? Ouch, that's an outie, not an innie. Bezzy, no one will believe us anyway, come on. That's a good point. Ooh, I love animals, won't you pet my pussycat? That's it, right there. I want it right here, right now. I've never done this before. I'm so nervous. What are you doing with that cane? Oh, no. You can put it anywhere you want it. Come on. I want it. May I have it, please? Oh, please. Oh, right there. That's the spot. Oh, that's the spot. Oh. I love you, sweetie. Have a good night. See ya.
Ah.
The promos are done.
Sweet Melissa, who can get you in a better mood, Fuzzy?
Nobody.
We will be in a good mood for the rest of the night tonight.
Um, 877-692-1027 is the toll-free phone number.
Hi, you're on Ron and Fez.
You wanna pretend?
No.
There goes the good mood.
That I'm Harry Potter, and you guys are my servants. And we can even pretend this in real life, if you want.
No!
Why?
Well, first of all, we can't pretend things with you. We're adults.
Right.
And second of all, why would we want to pretend that we're Harry Potter's servants?
Because I'm the leader.
All right, Harry.
And you're the...
Go ahead. What are we?
You guys are like, really bad, and your wands are, like, really bad as well.
Okay.
Is that why we're servants?
Yeah.
Okay.
And you also have wands, but they're not good.
All right, so we have wands, so we're like wizards.
Yeah.
Right, so we have some powers time.
All right, now maybe I'll take my wand and I'll turn Fez into something.
No!
You
don't have that power.
All right, don't.
No, you have bad wands. My wand is really powerful.
Well, can we get other wands somewhere?
No, you guys are only servants. You're lucky that I even gave you wands.
Well, we do feel
you gave us bad wands.
We're kind of lucky for that part, Fez.
Yeah.
What if I tape Fez's wand to mine, and then we make one super wand?
Right.
No.
What?
Even if you did, that wouldn't be as good as mine.
All right.
It would still be bad.
I have a feeling my wand is just a big pen.
All right, so we got wands, and you're Harry Potter.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So pretend
that
we're fighting an evil monster or something.
All right, and like I take my wand and I just start to try to make the monster turn into like a frog or something.
I'm the one who says things.
Okay.
Then what happens?
All right, so we're fighting.
Pretend?
Yeah, we're pretending.
That you try to turn him into a little toad or something.
Right.
but it doesn't work since that yours is really bad. And I try.
Yeah.
And I, like, kill it somehow.
Sure.
And everybody likes me because I kill stuff.
Right. And then they like
that person.
Well, they like me and Fez too, right? Since we're a team.
No one even knows you. You're just servants.
What if I
have bad wands?
But what if I pointed my wand and concentrated real hard and lightning bolts came out of it?
No! You don't have that power. Right. No one does except me.
How do you get all the powers and we get none?
Because I'm pretending. I'm the one that says things.
Do we have any good powers whatsoever?
You can just, like, shoot stuff that's, like, really not powerful.
All right, just shoots dumb stuff.
Yeah.
All right.
All right, so then the three of us become big heroes.
No!
What?
Only I do. Because remember, you guys didn't even kill it.
All right, then why would we want to play this game?
I know. We don't get to do anything cool.
It's fun.
For who?
It's only pretending. It's not real life. It's only pretending.
All right.
So now pretend.
Yeah.
That I start putting you guys into different shapes with my wand.
Okay.
And everybody starts laughing at you.
Why? What shapes are we in?
Like in stupid shapes. We're like in circles and squares.
We're in stupid shapes now. Why would you do that to your two helpers?
Right.
No, I make people laugh. I also do that. I also have the power.
Like comedy. Like wizard comedy.
Oh, brother.
But all more right, powerful.
And then we burst out of our shapes.
No.
And we have powers.
You don't have that power.
I'm not playing this game.
I'll tell if you want to play.
You better.
I'll turn you into a shape.
You can't because this is all just pretend.
Yeah, it's pretending, Kenny Allen.
It's fake, and this is why you don't have friends.
I'm gonna tell.
You better not tell.
I have friends.
Right, no, you don't
tell.
No, you're not our.
No,
we're not your friend. You've done things to us,
and you're not our leader either.
Yes, I am. I'm gonna tell.
Don't.
I'm telling.
No.
I'm telling.
So.
Now he's gonna tell. Great. If we end up not getting to see this movie Friday, because we're grounded.
My kid drives me nuts.
Ah. I mean, there went the good mood.
I'm willing to do stuff, but anything that we want to do is out.
We don't get to pretend one bit.
It's unfair.
It is unfair.
It is. That's true.
I mean, he doesn't play well.
No,
he's got a problem.
Yeah.
He's gonna have problems later on in life. When he's later years, Kenny Allen.
877-692-1027. Hi, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hello, Ron and Fez show.
Hello, DC Skyves Cooley.
Well, hello, Iris. How are you doing, sweetheart?
Pretend.
Oh God, not another one.
That I make it shape.
Iris.
No. I say the thing.
You're just copying what Kenny Allen just put us through.
Well, I thought all the characters were calling. There's a new name for me.
You have a new name, Iris?
There's a new girl in town.
Oh, great. I can't wait to hear this one.
And her name is Sweet Iris.
Sweet Iris?
Ooh. Dude, it's too big for Sweet Iris.
Oh, Iris, don't tell me you're going to start the sexy talk.
You don't know how much I need it in Bay Ridge, Brooklyn.
All right, Iris, this just isn't going to work.
Is that a Nathan's hot dog, or are you in a good mood?
Okay, this is completely unsexy, Iris.
I'm trying to get back on top. I am being shoved down the character line.
Where would you say you fall into the character line at this point?
It looks like I'm underneath Latter-day Harry Potter.
Wow, that...
I'm listening to the time you give the bimbo scientist and Sweet Iris, who all the boys like.
She is Sweet Melissa, not the bimbo scientist.
But what happened to Sweet Iris? That was my bit.
We never did Sweet Iris. You did some crappy news you can use for the Jews.
That was good. which we all loved.
Mm-hmm.
And
right.
then I turn around and it's doom. I'm the man, and I'm Harry Potter Jr., mate. And I drink my own pee. The next thing I know, Iris is just out.
So you're feeling slighted.
I'm feeling slighted.
So in order to fix that, instead of doing a better job yourself, you're just trying to steal poor sweet Melissa's act.
Just do me a favor and hit the sexual healing for me. Get up, get up. Sexual healing.
Iris, that is not your music.
Get up, get up. Ooh, I like to have sex. Oh. Get up, get up.
Great, she's just going to sing it herself.
My ass is tingling. Get up, sexual healing.
This is so not sexy, Iris.
Grab my enema bag and go to town.
All right.
I'm sweet Iris.
These are not going to make promos. We're not going to have sweet Iris promos.
Who's got the massingale?
Ew.
Sweet Iris.
You're just disgusting. You're not sexy at all. You're just gross.
I'm just not feeling like I'm part of the show anymore, boys.
Well, that happens, Iris. New characters come and go.
But I don't want to go. This is my show. It's the Ron and Fez and Sweet Iris show.
It has never been the Ron and Fez, by the way, and Sweet Iris show.
I always say every show needs a recovering addict. A fag and an old lady. I've said that time and time again.
We
don't need the Kenny Allens, the sweet Patricias.
Sweet
we
Melissa.
We don't need the Jabbas. All we need is the original three.
Iris, you're just a little off your game. You're in a slump and these characters are outshining you.
I went through some bad times lately.
What's going on in your life? What's so horrible?
Well, I found a lump on my breast.
Oh, no, that is awful.
Now, the good news was that it was a cupcake that I must have dropped down there.
Well, then that is
but
good news.
But for 2 weeks, I could feel a lump on my breast.
Yeah, well, you should check if you have missing pastries.
Thank God the doctor reached in there and said it's just a cupcake.
Right, yeah.
And it was delicious.
Was he able to get all the icing?
Most that hadn't hardened.
Good.
So I just recommend to you ladies, don't wait as long as I did. Check your breast, because it just may be a cupcake.
Okay, thank you for that medical advice.
Or, in extreme instances, a piece of pie.
Really? That's happened to you before?
No, I would love to come in. When's my limo coming?
Iris, you're not coming in and you're not getting a shooting star limo.
What?
There's no reason to send a shooting star limo for you, Iris.
Nothing?
Well, no, you have no reason to come in.
How about a Chinaman in a rickshaw or something?
Iris...
How about a movie in a stolen Pontiac? I don't care what I gotta do here.
All right, Iris, all right. You're not getting a ride in here.
Just walk.
You know, you're not gonna participate in any of the beer games, the beer drinking games.
I would love to.
You're not gonna be part of the foot fetish, that's for
sure.
Come
in and lick my toes, do a body shot out of my belly button.
Oh my gosh, no one could drink that much. Iris.
What do I gotta do here? I'm trying to get back on top.
Iris, you...
I was Iris, damn it. Sweet Melissa was still blue and green, and I was Iris from Bay Ridge, Brooklyn.
You're still Iris.
The news you could use for the Jews.
Yes, we all know.
We
it was
made
late
this
news.
Show.
Mm-hmm. Right.
We don't need these other people fed.
I'm sorry, Iris, but they seem to be rising in popularity. No one's more popular than Sweet Melissa right now.
I've got a new bit.
All right, what's your new bit?
Get your balls out.
Oh, is this pathetic.
Don't get rid of me, Kiki.
All right, now you're just doing Paulo's Oscar blur bit. You need something new, something fresh, original.
I drink my own pee.
Now, that's just Joe Jr., isn't it? Isn't it? It's just Joe Jr.
What's going on, guys?
All right, that's the jobber. You're just stealing from other characters now, and I must say, shamelessly. Iris?
Yes?
You're gonna have to come up with something new and original and fresh.
Got my stomach stapled.
Oh, you did not, and you're not the ass man.
I'd love to come in and show you my staples.
You do not have staples. Now, this is just sad that you're trying these desperate attempts. You're not getting a limousine.
What if I dressed up like Lara Croft?
Please don't. Please don't. Whatever you do, don't dress up like the Tomb Raider.
This will be my last call to this crap show.
Now, Iris, don't go away mad.
Oh, I'm going away mad.
Well, don't, Iris.
And I hope to hell you both rot in hell.
All I'm saying is you can't do the other character's acts.
Well, why don't I pretend I'm you and go around with guys?
All right, Iris.
I'm just saying what no one else has the guts to say.
Iris, you're way out of line here.
You're out of line.
You're loopy tonight.
You're loopy and you ruined everything.
You're loopy.
You're loopy.
And you're not getting a loopy limousine.
Is there anyone else there I can talk to?
Apparently not. I'm the only one who seems to put up with you.
Could I be an older version of O&A Kid?
No. You're not going to be O&A Senior Citizen.
That I hope tonight I die in my sleep.
Oh, Iris,
I hope the hell I die in my sleep.
Iris.
And I hate you both. I hate this show.
Iris.
And I pray.
Yes.
On my hands and knees.
Oh, great.
That the Taliban kills your whole family.
Oh, now that's awful. That is the worst thing I've ever heard anyone say.
Because you're Arabs.
It's
a show of Arabs.
We are not Arabs, and you know it, Iris.
You're down on your knees to Mecca six times a day.
We are not.
You're down on your knees six times a day. I don't know if you're praying.
Iris, now these personal attacks aren't going to help you with your part in the show.
It's Thanksgiving. It's time to stuff it in. That's all I'm saying. I'm yours.
All right, there she goes mad. Now she's just furious. But she can't come in here and start stealing Kenny Allen's stuff and Sweet Melissa's act.
Could we have one night where you're not in a fight with somebody first?
I'll tell you what, that woman knows how to push my buttons, that's for sure. Oh, she's frustrating.
You're all worked up now, Fezzy. It's okay.
Oh, I know. I'm just livid. I'm just livid. And she always threatens that she won't call. She'll call again. She'll call.
We shouldn't be worried.
No.
I'm a little worried.
She'll call.
I think that's it for her.
She's
done.
That's her big act. Acting like she's quit. When she's not even hired.
No! Hey, why did they take the Kenny Allen off my instant replay?
I have no idea why they would do that.
Or is it just a matter of they moved him?
He may be moved.
I can't have him moved every day, though.
Al Dukes, do you know anything about that? On the instant replay?
Yes, this stays here forever.
I have balls. I'm gay. I have balls. I'm gay.
Al insists that that stays on there.
Oh, I got news for you. I'm not going to be, trying to program this thing during the show.
They got it on a hidden bank?
Right. I'm not going to play that game.
877-692-1027.
We're on a Fez.
Ron and Fez, 1027 WNEW.
We're Ron and Fez, the toll-free phone number, 877-692-1027. Remember, go to ronfez.net, play the football pool there. You win the football pool. This week's winner will receive a Samsung Yep MP3 player. Remember to visit the new Samsung store at the CompUSA location in Manhattan at 420 Fifth Avenue.
Sweet Melissa is dancing a little bit to Joe Jackson for his fest.
Nice. You're a good dancer.
Fezzy, maybe if you don't go home, you could go to Sweet Melissa's house for Thanksgiving.
I still haven't decided if I'm getting on that plane yet or not.
You want us to do an adopt a Fez?
Operation Fezzy Claws.
I was just going to drop it off at your house and sit with you.
That's what, no the Turk?
Sure.
Now I'm Meals on Wheels.
I've got to take a plane home for Fez. And I don't know if Iris has anyone to be with for Thanksgiving.
Probably not.
Joe Pooh, your family getting together around a plate of Pooh?
Yeah.
For Thanksgiving?
All two of us.
It's all dark meat there.
Just you and your sister?
Yeah, that's it. And then we take a shower together. Rinse and off the gravy.
That's a Joe Pooh. Him and his sister, they lick gravy off of each other, then hop in the shower together.
Then it's the Roman tuck. I can't stand Thanksgiving. It reminds me of how weird we are. Now I hate Bayonne.
Joe Pooh was telling me he makes his mom cook an enormous-sized turkey.
Then he has sex with it.
That is way too big for the whole family to eat, because he likes to eat it up to weeks later, even after everyone says, "Ooh, don't eat that. It's poison."
Now, what are you, a turkey sandwich guy?
No, I make a dinner every day, breakfast, lunch, and dinner.
And how long?
And is this leftover turkey?
I'll just eat it till everything's gone, until I'm making cranberry sandwiches.
So you celebrate Thanksgiving well into December.
You know what you ought to do? Ask your mom to make a turkey a couple other times a year. Maybe you won't crave so bad.
It's the only time she cooks. It lasts right until around Christmas time.
Would it hurt you to pop a small bird in May?
For the rest of the year, it's those frozen pizzas by Celeste.
Let's just be thankful we live in Bayonne. God bless Bayonne.
She used to try to trick us, giving us pigeon on Thanksgiving.
Who all gets together at the pool house?
Just me, my mother, and my sister.
That's it?
None of the aunts and uncles? None of the cousins?
No.
That's always sad.
And my grandma has indigestion, so she won't eat my mom's gravy.
I've had those far away from home Thanksgivings where you just, I'm going to make myself a turkey anyway and have a friend over. It's so depressing.
Oh.
And you're acting like, oh, this is great, isn't it? And you're just thinking, I can't believe it. I'm an animal. And then also, even if you go to a restaurant, I've tried that.
Right.
You know, you go out to a restaurant and you're like, oh, this is great, huh?
Yeah.
And you're just
no cleanup.
Right. And you're thinking, and then finally you think to yourself,
yeah,
you know, if I'm dead, nobody would care. You're at that point. Then I start thinking, you know, I'm going to have to save some money in case I have to hire pallbearers for the day I die. I'll have to call a temp service. I'm dying. How much for six guys to carry me?
And act like they knew me.
Right.
How much to go along with a bit.
How much you get an Italian woman to scream and cry over my grave? Anything at all? How about a black woman to dive in and say she's got to go with me? What would that cost? 500?
Well, I guess I'll be watching the football in peace and quiet this year. That's a good thing. That'll be nice.
So instead, I get together with my large family that I hate. We only see each other. We only see each other on Thanksgiving, and it's so tense.
Want to trade? You can come to Bayonne. I'll go wherever you go.
Please. I can't imagine. They would eat you alive, Joe Pooh.
Would they?
Yeah.
What if I talked like this the whole time?
I'll sit you between my grandparents.
You'd be eating out in the yard.
I don't know. So what are you going to do, Fez?
I haven't decided. It's 1 week from today.
What about go over the pool house? There's plenty of room there.
Yeah, come on over.
Giant turkey? I am not going to the pool house.
We'll even wash the turkey first.
I am not having Thanksgiving in Bayonne.
Why not? Are you too good?
Yes.
You're too good for Joe Pooh and his family?
Yes.
That's not nice. I offered you greetings.
Seriously, greetings. He wanted you to be there. All right, where's the extended family? Where's the cousins and uncles and all that, Joe?
Yeah.
They're spread out, Georgia, Texas, Florida.
It sounds like they're on the run. Nice. He's got a family on the lam right now.
On a seven-state killing spree. Don't you have anyone in that family that's done some good in their life?
I might.
That made something of themselves?
Yeah, there might be one.
Who's the black sheep?
There's Senator Pooh from Delaware.
Hawk says, I love it when Hawk hands me a note with a joke on it.
What did it say?
It happens maybe once a month. Pooh mentioned all the white trash states. Where his relatives.
That is true.
Yeah, that any of your relatives, maybe in Massachusetts or somewhere that low rent white people don't go?
No. We're the upper class.
Nice.
They're the poos that made it.
Right. Made it to Bayonne. Land of opportunity.
The other poos sit around and talk about them.
They think they're special because they're not in jail. All the poos here in Pooville. Now, who is this one shining star that you got in your poo clan?
Dr. Pooh. Dr. Poovy. We have a podiatrist we're really proud of. She's a figure skater.
What?
She's with the ice capades. Oh, she thinks her poo don't stink. You seen Disney on Ice? She's goofy. Literally goofy. Sometimes she'll bring her skates over to the house. We'll freeze a puddle in the backyard.
Who is this figure skater in your family?
Well, she won the gold. I think it was in 96, so I get to hear that all the time.
You, wait a minute. You've got a gold medalist in your family?
Yeah, we've got one.
Who is it, Kurt Angle?
I wish.
It's true. It's poo.
It's poo. It's damn poo.
Melissa just laughing at your life.
No.
Yes, you're laughing at his life.
She didn't say that.
And you know what? Already I'm saying it's a lie that you got any gold medal winner in your genetic pool.
Yeah,
it ain't happened.
It's in the blood. I just didn't get it.
Wait a minute. Here comes your cousin.
And he's drinking poo.
All right. Who won the gold in your family? The gold poo?
Tara Lipinski.
You're lying.
Tara Lipinski, the figure skater, is in your family.
Yeah, first cousin.
You're the first cousin?
Yeah. No way.
She's got to be generations apart from you if she is even in your family.
Although, look at the forehead. That's a Tara Lipinski forehead.
No, it's a Joe Pooh forehead. She has mine.
How's she related to you?
First cousin.
I mean, give us
we
one.
We know that.
Brother of what?
Father's sister's daughter.
Your father's sister's daughter. Your aunt's daughter.
Sounds right.
You can't get any closer than that.
No, that's right there. I mean, you share grandparents.
You swear to God.
I swear to God. Why would I lie?
Wasn't she just on TV Sunday? Didn't she have a big spooktacular?
Oh, yeah. The hip-hop on ice, yeah. Great.
No, that's a big deal.
Yeah.
So when's the last time you saw her?
Probably about 8 months ago.
Where at?
What was that circumstances?
Funeral.
One of her ice skates break?
Hawk, I need you to look up Tara Lipinski, not Kurt Angle.
What can you tell us about her? What would only you know that if we look up, we can find out it's true?
Right, yeah.
And I'm telling you right now, Joe, if you're lying, I'm going to heart punch you.
What didn't I say? My cousin was Joe Montana or something? We have things in common.
That's true. But I know, but you're just it seems like you're a natural born liar.
Well, I am, but this is the truth.
All right, where was she born?
Bayonne.
That's not what it says on TaraLipinskiOnline.com.
What's it say?
It says Sugar Land, Texas.
That's where she lives now.
It says birthplace. It says hometown is what it says.
Let me ask you something. If you became famous, would you say you were from Bayonne?
I'd already hear Paul's got you in another line.
All right.
Hey, Paul, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, Paul.
Hey, guys, what's up? Joe Pooh is full of crap. There were no Winter Olympics in 96, 94, and 98.
What's the big deal? I don't follow the Olympics. I just know she was in them in the late 90s.
And you said... She was born in Bayonne when she was it.
She was.
It says her hometown is Sugar Land, Texas.
Well, that don't mean she was born there.
Yeah, see?
You know where she lives now? Is it Sugar Land?
That's where she lives now.
Oh, sure. Now you know.
All right, hold on. Here's another person who thinks Pooh is lying. Hey, Jeff. Jeff, you're on Ron and Fez.
Listen, Joe Pooh's full of crap there. Lipinski was like 15 or 16 when she won the gold, and that was no way that was 96. She would have been 13 or 12 then.
Yeah, she was just a kid.
What's the difference? I don't know my own sister's age, and I live with her.
He has sex with her.
Yeah, that's
crap.
You.
I mean, all right, you say you don't follow the Olympics. How can you have a first cousin in the Olympics and not want to follow it?
Well, because
I went nuts because somebody I knew a skier, and I watched everything there was about this mutt.
From Nagano.
Right.
I remember that.
And the guy didn't even make the top 40, and I'm staying up to 3 o'clock in the morning because someone I know met him. I'm looking for any connection.
If Kurt Angle's my cousin.
If Tara Lipinski was my cousin, believe me, I'd be following her around.
Yeah, well, we're different people.
Oh, you got to go your own way.
Yeah, that's it. I'm not riding her
coattails. All right, let me ask you this.
What?
Does Tara Lipinski know you? Let me ask this. Your first cousin, could she pick you out of a lineup?
Yeah, absolutely.
What did she say to you when you saw her last at the funeral? What was that like? Was it like, was she just whisting it out like a celebrity? Or were you sitting there chummy with her?
No, it was like, hey, how you doing? Yeah, good. Just that small talk.
You win any gold medals lately? Why can't you get her on our show then?
Well, we only talk once in a while. That's the truth about it.
Believe me, I have cousins I barely talk to, but I could get them on the phone.
And why don't you skate?
I used to. I hung up the skates.
Look at his ankle.
Oh, my gosh.
His ankles are too thick to fit in a skate.
I couldn't stand an ice skate, so I roller skated for a long time competitively.
You're lying, dog.
I got pictures right here.
Of you? All right, let me see your pictures.
And I brought patches.
Patches?
Now, what were you, like a dance skater?
Yeah, kind of. Hey, what are you laughing at?
Yeah! All right, let me,
Oh, we got to pass these all around.
Look at the ass on Joe Poop. Like a refrigerator.
Oh, my gosh.
Now, look. Also, look at this, Fez. He's the only boy in these pictures. He's surrounded by little roller skating girls. Look at these gay skates. Look at the gay outfit.
They were cool skates at the time. You like the one with me skating in my underwear?
Joe Boo, your hairline is exactly the same.
He was born losing hair.
You started to lose your hair at 5 years old.
Told you.
Dang, short shorts.
Oh, is this you and Colleen Poe?
Yeah, that's Colleen Poe. I got the picture of the three of us, too.
Who's the third? Tara Lipinski?
Yeah, when we were younger.
No, really?
Yeah.
You're a liar.
Please.
Right.
All right, who's who? Who's Pooh? All
right, let me look. I'll be able to tell.
Ronnie, this is the undisputable evidence. Three infants sitting in a chair. Well, of course, it's Tara Lipinski.
You mock me.
Yes. Right. Oh, were you a fat kid?
So this little, it looks like 8-month-old, is Tara Lipinski.
The one in red is Colleen Pooh.
All right, so the other one is Tara Lipinski?
Yeah.
So you said Tara is older than Colleen Poole?
Yeah, by like a year.
All right, get Tara Lipinski's birth date. Hawk off of that computer.
All right, I'm reading the instant feedback. It's not one person. All right, yeah. Well, I've got some stuff here.
Oh, what do you got, Ronnie?
This is about Tara off of her website. We'll check out Joe Poole to see if he understands. Tara Lipinski, what is her favorite color?
Okay, good. That's a good question, Ryan. That's fair.
Yeah.
Blue?
Purple.
Purple? Anyone knows that.
What's her favorite number?
I'm not a fan. I'm a relative.
98. What food does she like?
Probably low-fat stuff.
Blackened fish.
Right.
What's her drink?
Favorite drink, Joe Poo?
I have no clue.
Coffee.
Who
which
wouldn't
we're understanding
know that?
Is bad for you now. You know nothing about her.
I work here 5 nights a week. I don't know what you guys are drinking.
You literally came here a week ago. But did you watch her in the Olympics?
Yeah, a little bit.
A little bit? Now, I didn't miss a damn thing out of that.
I was too a skating.
Her against that Asian girl. I'm freaking out.
Ronnie gets the triple cast.
I seen all of them, though. I was at a skating event.
Oh, you were roller skating that night?
No, I wasn't.
All right, who's her favorite actress?
Meryl Streep?
It's Meg Ryan.
Close.
All right, what's your favorite TV show?
Seinfeld.
And Who Wants to Be a Millionaire? You know nothing because this is a lie.
All right, hold on. I got a good one for you. What's your aunt and uncle's names?
All right, yeah.
First names.
Sarah's parents.
Pat and Jack.
All right, that's true.
Yeah, you got lucky.
That's interesting because he hasn't looked for anything else.
Earl, what's so funny?
He didn't have any hair then.
Yes, we've all laughed about that.
All right, so that is your dad's sister.
Yeah.
I know. Look at the ass on him, Earl, while he's skating. They tried to prime this one for the Olympics. And what in the world is this crazy elf suit you're in?
Oh, it was St. Patty's Day. We're going to the rink.
All right, get Colleen Poo on the other line. I'm going to ask her.
Can you do that?
I know that your sister would love to embarrass you as well.
Okay.
Right.
All right. Here's Jay. Jay, you're on Run a Fence.
Hey, what's up, guys?
Hey, hey Jay.
Sarah Lipinski is from Bayonne. It was in the local newspaper when she hit the Olympics, and there were signs all over Bayonne. I unfortunately live in Bayonne.
Now, probably Joe saw one of those signs.
Aha. Uh-huh.
Was with a cousin, so naturally he thought that was his cousin.
All right, so we do believe that Tara is from Bayonne. That's easy enough. But that she's...
That even shocks me.
But that she's the first cousin to poo.
What do you want me to bring, an old ice skates or something?
I
want to... We want her to come in and teach us to skate. We had some Olympic skater on the show before, remember, Fez?
We had Katarina Vitt.
Yeah, and she tried to teach Fez how to skate. Fez almost fell on her and she screamed.
I almost fell on her ankle. Out in the parking lot. It was bad. She was furious.
Hey, Dennis, you're on Run a Fez.
What's going on, guys? I wanted to ask Joe Poo. Is this gold medal Olympus, was she in the Special Olympics?
Yeah, did everybody win a gold medal? So you just naturally assumed it was Tara?
Later, no. Boys.
Sarah. She was in the Olympiscuit.
Really? Fred Durst is your cousin, too, I guess.
Yeah, a little bit.
All right, Ronnie, here's a very nice skating picture of Joe Poo as Zorro the Gay Blade.
Let me see this. Look at you. You look like Black Earl when he's going out for coffee.
Was there ever a day you didn't have a costume on?
No, I went through a lot of phases.
Colleen.
Oh, God.
All right, we got Colleen Poo on.
All right.
All right, before we do this, Fez, would we believe her if she backs up the same story?
Colleen Poo, I have no reason not to trust. She's never lied to us before, except maybe about the Roman duck.
All right, here's his roller skating patches. Why don't you put these on your coat?
Right, on that leather coat of yours.
You won him as the only boy who was a roller skating figure skater.
I did a triple sow cow to win the first one.
Ronnie, there's the love boat picture where he's dressed as Meryl Streep. Oh, God. Ronnie, oh, we got to get some of these on the web. Ronnie, for some reason, here he is with Iris. I have no idea how they met.
This is sexy. Sexy Joe Poo.
He's in a Playboy pose. Oh, my gosh. Ronnie, here's a nice Halloween where he dressed as a gremlin. And not even the mean gremlin, the little furry cute one.
That was a skating costume.
There's skating Santa Claus, who didn't need any stuffing.
That's you dressed as Santa?
Yeah, I did it for the kids.
You were a kid. Look at you.
I did it for the kids. What a nut. Oh, my gosh. What a fat F you were.
All right, here's the situation, Joe. All right, let's just, before we even talk to Colleen Poo, let me just ask the whole room. Does anybody believe that he's the first cousin of Tara Lipinski?
No.
I say no.
Yes.
Nice, Earl.
I say no.
Hawk?
No way.
Sweet Melissa?
No, sorry.
Wow, and she trusts everybody.
Now, here's the situation. Will his sister start to lie for him?
We have to see, is poo thicker than water?
Because I have seen those two come to each other's side when they're fighting, like, say, a Godzilla.
Oh, yeah.
They put the boots to that poor bastard.
Right.
Now, they'll fight each other, but if one turns on them...
Now, Ronnie, here's a picture of Joe Poo and Colleen Poo in their Giants jerseys. Either that, or it's Michael Strahan and his little sister. They're pretty bulky at this point in their lives.
Yeah, my little sister, Leonard Marshall.
Oh, my God, Joe. You were one of those kids who looked like an adult as a child. Now that you're an adult, you look like a child.
Yeah, unfortunate.
You look like one of those chubby high school football coaches.
All right, we got Colleen Poole on the line.
Oh, good.
Colleen Poole.
Hello?
Hello? Hello, it's Colleen Poole.
Hi, Colleen Poole.
All right, you're on the air, honey. We caught your brother Joe Poole in a lie. Again.
It's really not a lie, though.
All right, he claims that your first cousin is Tara Lipinski.
Yeah, it's the truth.
Now, how come you guys never brought this up to us before?
Because it's not a big deal.
Yes, it is.
If I had a famous cousin, I'd be screaming about it.
No, but she's not that famous.
What are you talking about?
She just had a network special Sunday afternoon.
She's now, since her gold medal, she's a multimillionaire. I saw her skating.
I'm going to find the book that she wrote, and there's a picture of me in there with her.
You're lying.
Oh, please.
I swear to God, from when I was younger, from when I was 5 years old.
And what'd you say? Me and the cousins I don't talk to.
Maybe you can go get your hands on the book, because I can't find it. It's called Triumph on Ice.
Fezzy, we can pick it up right now off of Amazon.com. We actually just looked that up.
Oh, okay.
Triumph on Ice, the Colleen Poole and Tara Lipinski story.
I have a picture of us actual picture.
The one where she's an infant?
Yeah, no, on the computer. You want me to email it to you?
Yeah.
Yes, please.
All right, I'm going to do it right now.
That'll prove everything. More pictures of babies.
Yeah, how old are you guys in this picture?
I think 5.
All right, why can't you guys ever get Tara on the phone?
Right.
Because I don't think she'd want to be on the phone. Hold on.
What? Are you told to, as a family, to stay away from her?
No, who said that?
What is it, Joe?
No, it's just, you know.
Don't embarrass her?
Yeah, limelight doesn't like to be near garbage cans.
Were you warned about this?
No, we, you know.
Let me ask you this. Is there a court order of any type? A restraining
no,
order?
No court orders yet.
I know no one can see these pictures. But, Ronnie, there's someone pushing a baby carriage. He's got a baby doll.
Joe, you were unbelievable. You're a hysterical baby.
And then here's the lead singer of Blues Traveler.
Right. Is that before or after he was Staple?
Hello?
Hello.
Hello.
I sent a picture.
Okay.
Where'd you send it? Ron and Fez?
Yes.
All right, hold on. I'll go over and check it. Fezzy, what were you doing with that picture at all times ready to go?
I know. Are you constantly getting called a liar?
Someone actually emailed it to me on the computer.
All right, which one are you on, the left or the... She's the one on the right, right?
I'm the one with the blonde hair.
Is anyone in skates?
Again, they're four-year-olds. No, probably three-year-old, right? In these pictures.
No, we're 5.
All right, there's no way to tell that it's Tara Lipinski, though.
Okay, I'm going to find the book, and it says my first and last name.
All right.
In the caption of the picture.
There's poo on every page.
The poo years.
Now,
this is, I'd like to see Tara Lipinski. This is her at her big special. Hello. I'm Tara Lipinski, and I eat my own poo.
I'm so glad I won the gold medal.
Don't give him my phrases. She'll take them and run with them, and I'll have nothing.
You have nothing. She's got everything. You got nothing.
The one thing you do have is a famous cousin.
She's probably making $800,000 a night. How about she helps buy you a decent jacket?
Right.
I'd settle for $2.
And pants.
And pants.
And new underwear.
All right, let's stop it here.
Get some underpants that aren't brown and yellow.
Now, Colleen, were you encouraged to skate?
No.
Not with those ankles. I'm looking at her baby pictures. I can't believe she got to walk.
I don't have fat ankles, weirdo.
Seriously. I don't know, Fezzy. Again, she's too young to know who it is.
To get an idea from the picture. And here's the thing. Why did one person get all the talent? You think it would filter through. You look at that Peyton Manning family. Every one of them's a quarterback.
Well, Pooh tried to be a roller skater. He wanted to be in roller derby.
I was a big quitter.
Why didn't you
quit everything?
Why didn't you get on ice?
I couldn't stand on the skates.
It's like the movie Twins. Arnold Schwarzenegger got everything. Poo, you're Danny DeVito.
It's
you're
not the
afterbirth.
Bad.
You're the afterbirth.
It's not that bad.
It is not bad.
It's horrible.
It's worse.
And you're not even allowed to talk to her.
And now you got your sister lying and sending baby pictures of two strangers. It's awful.
What did
so,
I make
so go out and buy the book.
Yeah, we're going to buy the book now.
Now all we're right, going to have to.
Stop plugging stuff on the show. Joe Poo, Triumph on Ice.
No, Joey's not in the book.
No.
Only I am.
How did you make it in?
I don't know.
Were you close to her, being girls? Were you closer?
When we were younger, we were.
Yeah, what happened?
How'd you grow apart?
Because she moved out of where we live.
She moved out of the town.
Who's that yelling in the background?
That's Joey's friend. You want to talk to him?
No. God forbid I talk to any friend of Joey's.
Do we need to get some Hank Williams on just to calm things out at home?
What's that about? What do you mean by that, Fez?
Joe's new dad enjoys the Hank Williams.
Hank Williams Jr.?
Yeah.
Or I Hank thought it was Williams. Senior.
I don't know, both of them.
There's what? A tear in my beard.
All right.
Sorry, I didn't know you were radio jock.
Brings back drunken memories by the RCA.
You can shut up. I'm enjoying this.
Joe Poo, you've given us one piece of information that says you're actually cousins with Tara Lipinski. You knew her parents' names.
How about my trust?
There is not one other piece of evidence, as I look at all these pictures, that proves Tara Lipinski is your first cousin.
You're a dog liar.
When could you get her to call the show?
I don't know if I can. She doesn't do shows.
Not in plays. We just saw her on today's show.
Now, how far did you... I saw the patches. How far did you get with the rollerblading? The roller skating?
I did skating for like 2 years.
And did you do routines and tricks and stuff?
Yeah, some of that. And I felt too gay doing it, so I quit.
What was your big finish? What was your big trick?
I would do like, I don't remember them, but they looked good then.
What weight class were you in?
They started to try to get me into that dance skating with another partner. It was too much.
Oh, my gosh.
I fell on
another guy.
All right, here's somebody who knows something about this, Fuzzy.
Yeah?
It's Foul Mouth Elmo.
Huh.
Hiya, Elmo.
Yeah, I believe him. I believe Joe.
You believe Joe Poo?
Yeah, yeah. I believe it. Let's call her Tara Lipinski.
Oh, that's not her name. You're just making fun.
Yeah, no, I believe him. I believe him, for real. He knew the parents right off the bat.
Right off the bat, he did know the parents. That's true.
Okay, but don't cuss.
Yeah, I believe him, fellas.
Why is Joe always out of the room?
And yeah, right. Joe's not here to talk to Foul Mouth Elmo. And Foul Mouth Elmo's the only one who believes Joe Poo.
All right, see you, Elmo.
Mm-hmm. Let me...
Oh, no.
That's Foul Mouth Elmo, a very foul mouth Muppet.
Fezzy, we got an MP3 player to give out.
That's right. It's a Samsung Yep MP3 player. You can visit the new Samsung store. That's at the CompUSA location in Manhattan at 420 Fifth Avenue.
Now, last night we did MP3 as a crowd.
Right. Those times when you walked in on somebody.
Right.
While they were doing it.
Yeah. So now we'll do something different tonight.
Okay.
What do we got tonight? What do we got to choose from?
When you got walked in on.
No. We got to be totally different.
I know. We have MP3's a crowd. Or no. It's
that was last night.
That was last night.
Yeah,
MP3 doors down. That's what it is.
All right. What's MP3's doors down?
Those are those horrible neighbors you've had to deal with.
Tara Lipinski would have a great story. I got the poos talking about me in New York. I'm trying to have a career.
Trying to make a living out here in Sugarland, Texas.
Okay. So here we go, folks.
Yeah, MP3 doors down.
Just bad neighbors. Now, you ever have a bad neighbor, Fez?
I got bad neighbors now. I mean, we got the Howler, Ronnie.
Yeah, right.
She's known in the building as the Howler.
Yeah.
Mentally challenged girl. Lives in the apartment right next door to me. very fearful, screams at night, goes into huge, loud crying jags only in the middle of the night. I mean, you would think someone's killing a baby, she's crying so loud, and it'll turn out that it's just because it's raining. And one time, she thought she couldn't turn her stove off, which is great.
Right.
And she's screaming, I'm burning alive in here, in the middle of the night. So I immediately throw a chair in front of her door and get myself down the fire exit, down the steps.
Well, you gotta save yourself.
Right. And then across from me is a person I like to call Hello Patty. Her gimmick is, her angle, is to constantly say hello to you over and over again, even right after she's just said hello to you.
All right, so you got two retards on your same floor.
Right, yeah.
Are you retarded that you're in this building?
I think I ended up in retard row.
Are you in a special ed building I don't know about?
I would think so, except there's not, you know, like bumpers. My apartment isn't safety proof.
Polo's got a better life than you. Hey, Fez, we'll take a break. We'll come back. Best bad neighbor story.
All right.
We'll give out the MP3 player.
We're on a Fez.
Ron and Fez. 1027 WNEW.
MP3 doors down. We're Ron and Fez. Your chance to win a Samsung Yep MP3 player. Want to hear about those bad neighbors? 877-692-1027. Of course, Joe Poo will be the judge. You have to get past him to get to the finals. He'll select from there.
Now, in Bayonne, the bad neighbor is Joe and his family.
Right.
White Trash Central. Here's Chris. Chris, you're on Ron and Fez. How you doing?
Hey, hey Chris.
Yeah.
Good. I just moved into an apartment complex, and one day I stepped out of the apartment complex.
Uh-huh.
I was going to work, and I stepped in a huge, huge turd. One of the most disgusting things ever. So I figured it was just... What?
God,
I'm just laughing.
We're laughing at you.
Yeah, so I figured it was just like some stray dog or something. So I go back inside, and the second day I run out again, step in more turd. I'm like, this is absolutely ridiculous. So I just figured that there's some dog or something. Anyway, so this continues for 2 weeks. 2 weeks in a row, every morning I open my door and there's a big turd.
Right there at your doorstep.
Right outside, right at my doorstep. So this is getting ridiculous. I'm thinking to myself, I'm going to catch this freaking dog and I'm going to shoot him, right? So I set up a little video camera right outside my door. It's like a hidden concealed camera, right? So I go, and then I check the tape the next day. Lo and behold, it's my next-door neighbor coming across, pulling his pants down, and defecating right
You're
in front of my doorstep.
You're lying.
Absolutely 100% true.
Why is he doing this?
I have no idea. So
this has
my
never
first thought
happened.
Was to rent a gun and shoot him right in his disgusting, defecating head, right? But I thought prevailed, and like I let it go on. I checked the video camera. He did this for 2 straight weeks. So in order to get him back, me and 7 of my friends went to like the Home Depot, bought cinder blocks. We took a group dump on each cinder block, went up to the top of the roof, and dropped a turd-filled cinder block right on his car. 7 cinder blocks full of turd on his car. 2 weeks later, he moved out of the apartment. I think he got the message.
You don't feel like you lowered yourself to his level?
No, I think it's one of the greatest achievements of my entire life.
And destroyed a car. This sounds like neighbors caught on tape.
Yeah, it really does. But, like, I stepped in turd, and I freaking smelled like fecal matter for 2 weeks.
Yeah,
he had
good
to pay
point.
For something. One of the most disgusting things ever.
Now, take swear it. To us this is true.
What? 100%. Not kidding you. I think he was mentally... Can you imagine a neighbor just coming and pulling his pants down and just dropping the bomb right outside on my welcome mat? It said welcome and then a big turd covering the welcome. Disgusting. I
now
think
what did you do to get him to this place?
I seriously think he was mentally sick. I think that mentally he was all effed up. I think so.
I'm lucky just having Hello Patty.
Yeah, I have no idea why.
Right, you should love her.
But I lowered myself to a standard. Me and my friends got bombed, just took that group dump and just dropped 7 cinder blocks, just wrecked the car. And
now, were you all sitting there at the same time?
No, actually, we...
Because that would
no.
be really close
no, because
friends.
That would be really gay. We actually synchronized our fecal matter patterns in that I called them all up and said, guys, if you have to drop a deuce, make sure you hold it and you don't do it for a long time because we're going
to... Everybody came through for you?
What?
All 7 friends
all
came
7
through for you?
All 7 came through because they held it, and then we went into the bathroom and we synchronized it and we each took it and then we carried... We actually were carrying the turds. Like the cinder blocks with the turds, we actually carried them up on the elevator, went onto the roof. The whole elevator smelled like freaking disgusting fecal matter.
I guess so.
So we do it, and we dropped, and we just let the turds fly, and No pun intended, but that's what happened, and frickin' his car was dead, and he smelled like turd, and I got some revenge, but...
Joe, do you believe the story?
I believe it.
Absolutely 100%
He's very passionate about his story.
Not kidding you, I'm really still angry about it.
It's not like your Tara Lipinski lie.
No.
If I would still see the guy today, I think I would kill him, but like, he moved out, and it was good that he moved out, because that was going to be only the beginning of the destruction.
And it involves poo.
What?
That's why Joe likes it.
That's true.
Absolutely.
That's why I like it.
So am I a finalist?
Joe?
He's in the finals.
All right.
Nice. Thank you. Do I hold on?
Yeah. You'll hold on there.
All right.
What a great story.
Oh, my gosh.
Melissa, what do you think?
It's really gross.
Well, you don't believe that either?
I don't know. It's just
no one believes anything that you say, Joe.
Doubting Donald's.
What the hell is that?
I thought it was Doubting Thomas. I don't remember Donald being one of the apostles.
He was one of the first and most negatives of all the apostles.
I guess so.
The doubting Donald. All right, let's go to Chuck. Whoops. Yeah, Chuck, you're on Ron Fez.
Hello, Chuck.
Yeah, how are you? My story is there's a woman that lived next door to me.
Yeah.
In Jersey, and she's about 5 feet tall, 250 pounds. She's a nut. And when growing up there, I had an older brother, and this girl she loved my brother, and she was always asking, you know, to go out on a date and everything else. So she used to come over to our house, ring our doorbell, and she'd come totally naked, asking for a stick of butter. She used to eat sticks of butter for some reason. I don't know why.
You're lying.
I swear, I'm telling you. Wait, it's not over yet. So then one morning, we didn't have air conditioning in our house, and we had the windows. It was really hot. I remember the windows were open. You could hear everything on the block. And we hear her yelling my brother's name. Billy, Billy. We're like, what is that? Look outside. She pulled somebody's mattress, laid it in front of our house, and she's totally naked in front of our house yelling for my brother, Billy.
You're lying.
No, no, wait. Then, when I got older.
God. That gets worse, man.
Yeah, it does. When I get older, I ended up being a cop in that town. And I used to walk the post. And I was a cop at 18, so I'm like crossing kids, okay, during the daytime uptown. She used to walk all the time up there. And she sees me, and she starts, you know, she recognized my last name, so she starts talking to me. And then she says, would you like to go out? And I said, oh, you know, I'm really flattered. Her name is Doris. I go, I'm really flattered, Doris, but, you know, I'm gay. Thinking that she won't bother me now.
Right.
Well, about, like, half an hour later, I'm crossing kids. She's on the other side of the street yelling, homo, homo, faggot, don't get near him! Just yelling it. And for, like, 2 months, every day, she'd go out there and just yell at me and tell everybody I was gay and stand, and there's nothing I can do. What am I going to do? She's crazy. But growing up next to her, she'd always do stuff, throw things at, like, the other little girls that would walk by, my little sister, spraying with a hose when they'd walk by. She was a nut.
Really? So this is a true story?
Absolutely true.
Is this your way of coming out of the closet, telling people you really are a gay cop?
Did she ever hook up with your brother, Billy?
No.
Oh,
she didn't.
Really?
But she just... she had to be 250. So like, real short, blonde, long hair.
So what they did, Ronnie, is they got cinder blocks, filled them with butter, and dropped them on her car.
All right.
I don't believe a word he says.
Oh, boy, I can prove it.
Up until the fat lady yelling homo cop at
you. You believe the other guy, but not this one.
Yeah, there's no poo in this one.
All right, Chuck.
All right.
He's not falling for it. It's a damn good story.
It's a great story, and please don't think that your stories have to involve poo.
Because they don't. But
thank
that'd be
you.
Nice.
This is for a Samsung, yep, MP3 player. 877-692-1027.
Hey, Kyle. Kyle, you're on Ron Fez.
Hey.
Hey, Kyle.
All right, my neighbors are really weird. All right, like during the fall, because we live at the end of the street in the bottom of hill, so there's a whole lot of leaves.
Okay.
And what they would do,
hell.
Yeah, nothing weird yet. And what they would do is wake up at 5 in the morning and rake all of the leaves into tarps and empty them onto our front lawn and then put fences up around their house so our leaves wouldn't blow back into their lawn.
All right, so because there was your leaves, they were so furious, they took them off their lawn and chucked them over to your house, right?
Yeah, and after raking them for hours, instead of putting them by the street or doing something somewhere else to pick them up, they put them on our street because they figured they were our leaves.
Was it your tree?
I don't know, I guess. I mean, it might have been, but...
Well, you know, Fuzzy, it's nature's tree at that point.
Yeah,
what did they
really
do? They cut all their trees down so a leaf would never touch?
No, they had all, like, evergreen trees, though.
Right.
They replaced all their trees with evergreen trees.
Yes, they did. Very strategic landscaping, so they didn't have to deal with leaves.
You should have just gave them that evergreen song by Barbara Streisand.
True. Plus, when they were really little, they would come over and yell at my parents and blame my brother for watching TV through their window.
You sound like the bad neighbors. Could you get them to call?
Hey, is that... No. They moved.
Joe Poo, what do you think?
That's not such a horrible story. That's the worst story you've had in your whole life?
Well, I'm sorry it doesn't involve poo, but geez.
Doesn't have to.
That's a good story.
Oh, some leaves blow onto my carport. I'm all upset.
Who calls it a carport?
What do you call it?
I think you're saying no, Kyle.
Sorry. Well, whatever.
Yeah, go rake a leaf.
All right, here's now you're just getting angry with people.
Why do you have to be mad? Why can't you just say not in the final?
Because the story sucks.
So what?
One time I was caught in a rainstorm and I got wet. Do I win?
You're mad because your cousin Terry Lipinski made it to the finals and you never did.
No, I'm not.
You're so jealous of Tara.
John, you're on Ron
Fez. Hey, guys, 2576. Hey, got three neighbors living across the hall from me and my roommate, two guys and a girl. Constantly coming over asking for cigarettes or beer, something like that. One of the guys comes over a couple weeks ago asking for a first aid kit. We're like, why? What happened? The female roommate, his girlfriend, had stabbed him in the chest for coming home from work late. And the cops came, and the other roommate hid in our apartment, peeking out the windows.
All right, so your neighbors are stabbing each other, right?
Yeah, the girl stabbed the guy.
Yeah.
And then the third roommate came, hid out in our apartment while the cops were going through their place, took her off to jail, and she moved back in about two or three days later.
Joe?
I like it.
Tasty.
Yeah?
All right. Hold on. I didn't even understand it.
I didn't get it. I think they were hiding out in his apartment. The fugitives.
But Joe went for that one.
Yeah.
Alexis, you're on a Fez.
Hi, Alexis.
Hi. Let's see, I live on Long Island, you know, really nice neighborhood, all these nice little houses, and then there's the one ghetto house with a little old Italian lady and all of these guys that are like in their 30s. It's the crack house. The cops are always there. Once the cops were there because they were hiding some guy that was escaped from jail for like murder or something in their basement, so they got arrested for aiding and abetting a criminal. There's always the weirdest stuff going on there. It's really freaky.
Have they ever showed up on Cops?
I don't know. I don't watch the show. But there's always cops here. Like, I swear.
What do you think, Joe?
Nah, it sucked.
Too dull?
Yeah, call us back when you're in prison.
All right. Sorry, honey.
Why can't you just say no?
Is that a problem?
Yeah, a little bit.
All right, Ryan, you're on Ron Fez.
Hey, Ryan.
Hey, what's going on, guys? Long-time listener, first-time caller.
Oh, cool.
Late at night. You know, I'm hearing these sounds across the street. The neighbors, they're building a tower on their roof. So I go downstairs, you know, in the middle of the night, and I hear these voices coming from my living room. Now I'm freaking out. I'm home alone, you know. I'm hearing these adult voices cursing, talking about drugs and stuff.
You should have probably taken some nails and put them on the steps, and then taken an iron and put them up on the string.
Oh, very home alone.
Yeah. Right. Yeah.
Well, I'm looking around. You know, it's pitch dark and not finding anybody. Now I'm scared crapless. It's coming from my answering machine and from my television. The tower was interfering with all the electrical appliances in the house and coming through when they're not even on. It's coming through the speakers.
How could that happen?
I'm not sure.
When Lori Partridge's braces turned her into a radio.
I'm looking all over the house.
Who are you living next door to? Mad Science?
I don't know. They're running something over there. My mom actually called the police. She was home alone when they heard
something. Again, with the home alone. You people are petrified when no one else is in the house.
Yeah.
What do you think, Joe?
Yeah, he makes the finals.
Oh, my God.
Really?
For him, he jumped to. The guy with the huge woman that's hassling him, no.
We are letting Joe Poo judge the MP3 Doors Down stories. I don't understand what his criteria is.
Well, I don't like my reception being messed up, so that'd be a nightmare for me.
It's only if it would bother him personally.
What reception are you getting with those rabbit ears?
That's his sister. Don't call her names. She can't help that.
He puts tinfoil on Colleen Poo's head so they can get ABC to watch the Tara Lipinski special.
I remember when we all played Fort together.
My you first... never took off your skates.
Remember when we played Doctor with Tara Lipinski? I got a little.
Natalia, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hi, Natalia.
Hi, how you guys doing?
Good. What can we do for you tonight?
Basically, I have a neighbor story. I have a neighbor who, she likes to feed all the neighborhood stray cats.
Ah, cat lady.
So she leaves out, like, you know, pans of food and stuff for the cats of the neighborhood, and then they come to our yard and start howling when they're in heat and making lots of noise and pooing on our yard, and it's really disgusting.
I hate a cat.
Oh. Yeah, it's pretty gross. And then she's also, like, one time we were having a garage sale, and we have, like, a shared driveway. And, you know, the garage, the people coming to the garage sale were, you know, looking at stuff and kind of walking on her side of the driveway. And she has this habit of, she likes to water the driveway. She likes to water the pavement for some reason.
Sure, so it'll grow.
Right, of course. So she's watering the pavement, and she was annoyed that, like, the garage sale people were walking on her side of the driveway. So she sprayed, like, one of the garage sale people. And it was just like, you're on my driveway, and this isn't my garage sale, and you need to leave. And, like, sprayed her with the hose.
You're killing my driveway. You're stepping on it.
I have to keep that wet for the cats.
Yeah, exactly. She has to keep it wet and clean for the cats so that they can come and make out on, you know, her driveway.
I just like you saying I have to keep it wet and clean.
Exactly.
That's nice. Wait a minute. That might be one for sweet Melissa. Go ahead, Melissa.
I like to keep it wet and clean.
Oh, my Lord.
That's my favorite. I like to keep it wet and clean, too, baby.
Oh, shut up, you.
Oh, Natalia, really sweet.
Natalia, the crazy cat lady.
Now we need the cat lady next.
Yeah.
Meow.
Well, Natalia, you were digging... No, Natalia, you're digging sweet Melissa a little bit?
What?
You're digging sweet Melissa a little bit?
Yeah, she's hot.
Yeah, she is.
Well, thank you, Natalia.
What do you think, Joe?
Yeah, Catwoman's in.
All right, Natalia,
nice.
Way to go.
Natalia, you did it.
I just want to say that I love Joe Poo, and I'm so glad he's back. I miss him so much.
Oh, that's very nice of you to say.
And I was going to count you out, too. I like you.
Yeah, Joe, you're the bomb.
I never knew this. Joe Poo has a fan.
Yeah, and I'm a bomb.
I'm Joe Poo's biggest fan.
Really?
Oh, by far and away.
How large of a woman are you?
Well, maybe not that way. I just meant, like, as much as I like Joe Poo. I think he's just the best.
Would you like to meet him and go out sometime?
Sure, I'd love to hang out with Joe Poo.
Joe, what do you think?
12 o'clock, meet me in Hoboken.
All right.
You are not going to Hoboken and you know it.
That's sad. All right, honey, I'm going to put you on hold.
Thanks, guys.
All right, you are in the finals, Natalia. What's up for grab is a Samsung Yep MP3 player.
Jamie, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hi, Jamie.
Hi.
Yeah.
What can we do for you, Jamie?
Okay, so my neighbor's a peeping Tom.
Okay.
And we found
out... You
put
out a little show for him?
No. We found out he was stalking our other neighbor, and he was actually hiding under my deck. We have one of those, like, little storage rooms under our house.
Crawl space.
He was hiding under there for a few days.
In your house?
No, it's kind of under the house. It's like a shed, but it's attached to the house.
So he's crawling around basically like under your porch or your sun deck for how many days?
Like 3 days.
What was he looking for, the jar of pennies you keep on today?
Yes, exactly what he was looking for.
What do you think, Joe?
Yeah, she's in the finals.
Jesus, well, are you another Big Poo fan, are you, Jamie?
No, not really.
Ah.
Can I cross her off now?
No,
you said she's in the finals.
She's my favorite.
Fez.
All right, hold on. We got to take a break, Fezzy.
All right, 877-692-1027. It's MP3 doors down. Bad, bad neighbors.
You can win a Samsung MP3.
A Samsung? Yep. And you can visit the new Samsung store at the CompUSA location in Manhattan at 420 Fifth Avenue.
We are the Ron and Fez Show.
Ron and Fez. 1027 WNEW.
We're Ron and Fez. With your chance to pick up a Samsung Yep MP3 player. Go to the new Samsung store. It's at the CompUSA in Manhattan on Fifth Avenue.
Now, sweet Melissa in here with us tonight, Fezzy, as well as Joe Poo.
Right.
You having fun with us tonight?
I'm having such a great time.
You sure?
Yes.
I hope you enjoy that shooting star limousine you're taking home.
All right.
And, Joe, I hope there's a freight train going to Bayonne that you can hop in the back of.
Absolutely.
Joe, we have some hobo stew for you to take home.
Oh, good. Grits and beans in a can.
Seriously, Joe, would you like to go back and forth in the limo? You think that would be fun?
That'd be outstanding.
I'll tell you what we'll do. Melissa, can you get a picture of yourself in that limo and give it to Joe so we can live through that?
You tease me like a little hungry dog.
You know there's a freight train. Pull one out.
Yeah, that's always fun, riding home on a barrel of hay. Barrel of hay.
You're like Star Willie.
You're like Bugs Bunny. You always find something. All right, let's, some of these people, because somebody wants to win this MP3 player.
Yeah, and Hawk says we're wrapping up a little earlier tonight, so we got to get in as many as we can.
Great, Hawk. What do we have, 40 minutes of spots before we do the next show?
Exactly, so apparently Hawk has somewhere to go tonight.
Oh, I understand.
That's why we're wrapping up early.
He's got to take the dogs out, as he says.
I don't know what he means by going to the black lab.
Hey, Alan, you're on Run of Fez.
Hi, Ellen.
How are you?
Well, cool. How about you, baby?
Cool, babe.
Okay. All right, thanks for calling. Bye.
All right.
All right, see ya.
No, you got a story, right?
Oh, yeah, I do.
Go ahead, give it to Joe.
I do. All right. I used to live in a garden apartment in Queens.
Nice.
Right?
It's my dream.
Yeah. Oh, it's fabulous. And my kitchen adjoined, my living room, rather, adjoined my neighbor's kitchen, right? In a little corner.
Right.
And
right.
Two old ladies, right?
Right.
One was a drunk, the other one was senile.
Okay.
All right? Both of them were quite miserable, and they used to love staring out their kitchen window into my living room. And they would shout all kinds of obnoxious things. There's a whole load of stories, but my favorite one is when we finally noticed that they were staring into our living room, we would start putting on a little show.
Who's we?
Me and hubby.
Okay.
Right. And he was only boyfriend at the time, but, you know, living in sin.
All right, so you like to get him naked in front of the old ladies.
Yeah, well, yeah, more than that, but yeah.
You're banging in front of old ladies.
Basically.
All right, for that, you demand a price.
Oh, thank you.
Joe, what do you think?
No, not unless she pulled out the electric phallus.
Don't own one, Joe, sorry.
Too
all right, sorry, Ellen.
All right.
Jesus.
Right. Her voice was awful.
Right. That was my problem, though.
Right.
Golly. As soon as I said, let's hurry this along, that woman takes all the time in the world.
Thank you, Ellen DeGeneres.
All right. Tim, you're on Run of Fez.
Hey, Tim.
What can we do for you, buddy?
Nothing much. My story is actually, when I was younger, I used to live next to this crazy guy. He had one arm. And he actually got to the point when I got older that he got tired of mowing his lawn, so he put gasoline all over his lawn and lit it on fire.
The one-armed man is burning his own lawn down. Was he drunk?
No, he was just crazy. He threw all his crap in his backyard, and his house looked like a haunted house. It was crazy.
Uh-huh. Joe, what do you think? The one-armed man burning up the neighborhood.
He's in the finals.
How can you not love him?
Joe Pulez, the Freaks. All right, Tim, you're making it to the final list.
All right, cool.
Hold on, brother, man.
877-692-1027.
Here's Mark. Mark, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, Mark.
Yeah, hi, Ron. Hi, Fez. How you doing?
Good. Mark, we're going to move this along. What do you got?
Yeah, I love your show. I used to have a neighbor, an older man, who used to go through my garbage. And actually, this is before recycling, and take out all the cans. And we caught him taking out old bread. And he said he was going to use it for the birds. But we found out later he was eating it himself.
Oh, that's awful.
That's just sad.
That's sad for him.
And this guy had plenty of money. It wasn't a financial thing or anything. He just like.
But he might have been crazy, right?
Yeah, and then we invited him over for a party for one time.
Oh,
and,
why wouldn't you?
Bread party.
Well, it was like a christening, and he came over to christening, and when he was all done, he and his wife took all the leftover cold cuts.
Uh-huh.
And
that's who you want near the baby.
Sure.
Yeah. Right.
They didn't send him an invitation. They just put some breadcrumbs that led up to the baby's room.
Well, we felt sorry for him. That's why we invited him over. But
I can tell you feel sorry for him. You're still talking about him years later.
Yeah,
eating out of your trash can.
He should have brought over leftovers from your garbage can for that little christening.
I brought some bread I found in your trash.
It was just kind of sad how he threw all the garbage all over the yard, and it was just kind of sad.
Okay. What do you think, Joe?
Finals.
What?
All right, I'm not going to intervene.
I like people who eat old food.
Sure you do. We all do. That's entertainment.
God, we said you're the judge.
Hey, hey, Ed, you're on Ron and Fez. Hey, Ed.
Hey, guys. Just started listening to you. You guys are great.
Thanks,
I used to have a neighbor who, little crazy little kid. You know, everyone's got those crazy neighbors.
Uh-huh.
He used to run around naked. Okay, there was something wrong with the kid. He was
right.
About 6 years old. He used to run up and down the street. One day, he ran into the bushes. He grabs this dead possum. He's swinging around by its tail.
Oh.
Throws it at my little brother. Hits him in the head. And he has to go get a rabies shot. His kid
Where'd
was
he
crazy.
Get the dead possum?
I know. Was he, like, keeping the dead possum for just such an emergency?
No, he was... I don't know. He just found it. He was scaring all the kids. We were all running away from him on our bikes. It was the craziest thing.
Are you sure it was dead? Because a lot of times they'll just play it.
No, it was dead. Some other times...
Joe?
No, I don't believe him.
Joe Pooh.
Joe?
I don't believe you.
You never know who Joe's going to go for.
I know. You never know. You just have to catch him at a good moment, I guess.
Sorry, Ed. Maybe if an old man picked him out of the garbage can.
All right,
pick a possum out of a trash can.
Hey, Max, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hello, Max.
Hey, Ron and Fez. I was at the go-go bar with my neighbor one night, and he asked me to borrow $300 for some blow.
Uh-huh.
So I loaned it to him, and he never paid me back.
Well, that's all part of the fun of having Mitchell Walters hanging out with you.
As your neighbor, lock it up, buddy package.
Could I ask Melissa to say something?
Yeah, real quick.
Melissa, could you say, not so loud, Daddy, Mommy will wake
all
up?
All right, that's awful.
We won't do that.
Diana, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hi, Diana.
Hello?
Yeah.
We had a serial killer turn out to be our neighbor. He was my brother's friend. We used to come to all of our parties, you know, birthday parties. My brother was little. And he turned out to be Kendall Francois. He killed 8 prostitutes and kept them in his house. Now, that's a winning story. Come on.
The house that you were neighbors with?
Yes.
Where was this?
It was around the corner. Kendall Francois.
What town was it in?
New York.
Yeah.
Too bad Francois didn't get in fisticuffs with you.
All right.
That's a true story.
Well, that's a good one, but
yeah. He was a neighbor. Come on. How many people have that in their neighborhood? You know?
I just don't think you personally made it colorful enough. That's all.
I didn't kill anybody, but.
I'm sorry to hear that. It's up to Joe.
Nah, she's out.
All right, sorry.
Sorry.
I would have voted for you.
I think the voice led to the killings. He was my neighbor.
Hey, Mike, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hello, Mike.
Hey, when I was younger, I had a weird Asian family that used to live next door, and they used to hang up on the clotheslines in their backyard. They used to hang dead, skinned rabbits.
Hey, this duck's still alive! Ah, and the rabbit's still honking! This duck's still alive!
To me, it was the scariest thing since Skeletor, because I never had friends come over.
Get out there and see if them rabbits dry yet!
Are you sitting on the toilet talking to us?
It's a toilet shout-out.
Thank you. He's in. I love dead rabbits.
Oh.
What part like wanted the dead rabbits?
Dead
or him
rabbits
on the
and him on the toilet. I got such a vision.
All right, Mikey, you're in the finals.
The nice. Toilet shout-out.
All right, we got to actually give this out.
Yeah, we got 4 minutes left.
So you pick one out while you're thinking about it, Fezzy. It's the Ass Man.
Oh, nice.
We haven't talked to him since last night. Ass Man, you're going to do a weigh-in and check out.
I'm an ass man.
Spy report.
Spy report.
We have a new total.
All right, how much have you lost since your stapling, Ass Man?
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, I have lost a total of 71 pounds.
Wow. Nice. Way to go, Ass Man.
We could see it last night. We told you.
I am now a svelte 435 pounds.
Wow, congratulations, buddy.
You are moving in on the 400-pound mark.
Yes, I am.
That's very thin on the moon.
Stop it, Joe. He's on his way.
He is.
He dropped 70 pounds in what? 3 months?
Yeah.
2 months? How long has it been?
2 months.
Two months.
Nice.
Pretty soon you'll be the saggy ass man.
All right, Joe. You have work to do. Thanks, ass man. We got to go, buddy.
Fuck you, ass man.
Ass man.
Joe, we got to pick a winner here.
I've got one.
You've got one. All right.
Now, this is, of course, Fezzy.
for the MP3 Doors Down contest.
For a Samsung Yep MP3 player, visit the new Samsung store at the CompUSA location in Manhattan. That address, 420 Fifth Avenue. Joe Pooh.
The winner is... Tim, with the one-armed neighbor that lit the lawn on fire. I love old guys playing with fire.
A one-armed man lighting his entire lawn on fire is the winner of the Samsung Yep MP3 player.
I like any one-armed man who pins his shirt up. So his sleeves is not falling around out there.
Right. So it's actually pinned to the upper part of what's left of the shirt.
Nice. Well, that's it for us. We'll have more of these MP3 players. If you want one, go to ronfez.net. That's where the sweet Melissa always hangs out, by the way.
Oh, yeah.
You can play the football pool there at ronfez.net. Winner of the football pool this weekend wins the Samsung Yep MP3.
Also, we're doing a parody song contest that will take about a week. If you got a parody song on MP3, send them to ronfez@wnew.com.
So start thinking of your parodies now so you can get in on that to win the Samsung Yep MP3 player.
Sweet Melissa, it's wonderful. I can't wait till the new promos are done.
I can't wait either.
It's great to have you here.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, sweet Melissa, for being your sweet self and telling us about science tonight.
Aww. You'll be back Friday for the pajama party?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, we're having an all-girl pajama party in here Friday night.
Nice, okay. Joe Pooh, thank you for your work.
Thank you. Joe Pooh, this is your last night with us, so we thank you very much.
Oh, we
no
appreciate
pajama
that.
Party? No. Hey, Joe, time to say see ya, buddy.
Last night,
they're
huh?
Hey, Lou, what time to say sip?
Hey, Lou.
Hello.
Time to say sip.
Yeah.
Sip! Hey, Jesse, Anthony, Steve, and that's it, Fezzy. We got to get going.
Again, thanks again to Shooting Star Limousines for bringing our sweet Melissa to us. 631-447-2727.
Rich, Manny, and Eric, time to say sip. Sweet Melissa, let's hear you sip.
See ya.
So cute. Like a girl.
That's a dainty see ya. Oh, and by the way, tomorrow, Paul O.
Oh, God.
Oscar blurbs Harry Potter. That's the big film.
I hope the real Harry Potter comes in tomorrow, later day, Harry Potter.
And goes toe-to-toe with Paul O.
And discovers a little bit about Harry Potter before he comes walking in here half-assed.
I'll let him know.
Also, we want to give a big shout-out to our good friend and first cousin, Tara Lipinski. Tara, you're the best, baby.
Skate on. Skate on, Tara.
Oh, how you mock me.
You're all... You're... Remember, you're a poo.
We know you're a poo, honey. Till tomorrow.
We're Ron and Fez. We will be back tomorrow at 7 o'clock, right after the Opie and Anthony show.